calling of the roll? Is there any motion for the calling of the roll?
Mr. Chair, move to dispense with the calling of the roll.
Second.
There is a motion by the Honorable duly signed by the Honorable Joey Salceda, that we dispense with the calling of the roll. Is there any objection? Chair hearing none. Same is approved. The next matter would be, before we proceed to the next matter, may I acknowledge and recognize members present in person or via Zoom. First, in the order of appearance, the chairman of the Committee on Ways and Means, the Honorable, the gentleman from the 2nd District of Albay, the Honorable Joey Sarte Salceda. The chairperson of the Committee on Health, from the gentleman from the Lone District of Batanes, the Honorable June B. Gatoff Jr. The champion of education in this Congress, the representative from ACT Teachers Party List, the Honorable Franz L. Castro. Morning. And on Zoom, we have with us the gentleman from the 6th District of Bulacan, the Honorable Salvador A. Plato. The Lone District, gentleman from the Lone District of the Mountain Province, the Honorable Maximo Y. Dalog Jr. From Pusong Pinoy Party List, the Honorable Journey Jet Misay. From the 2nd District of Zambales, the Honorable Doris E. Maniquez. From the Lone District of Catanduanes, the Honorable Leo R. Rodriguez. From the 1st District of Cebu City, the Honorable Rachel Marguerite B. Del Mar. From the 2nd District of Agusan del Norte, the Honorable Dale B. Corvera. From the 1st District of Agusan del Sur, the Honorable Alfel M. Bascug. From the 4th District of Bukidnon, the Honorable Arini L. Roque. From the 2nd District of La Union, the Honorable Dante S. Garcia. From the 6th District of Quezon City, the Honorable Marivic Copilar. From the Lone District of Muntinlupa City, the Honorable Jimmy Fresnedi. From the 2nd District of Misamis Oriental, the Honorable Bambi B. Emano. From the Lone District of Lapu-Lapu City, the Honorable Maria Cynthia K. Chan. From the 2nd District of Cebu City, the Honorable Eduardo R. Rama. And from the 2nd District of Laguna, the Honorable Ruth Mariano Hernandez. With that, may I also recognize over Zoom the lady from the 2nd District of Cavite, the Honorable Lani Mercado Revilla, and from the 3rd District of Batangas, the Honorable Maria Teresa V. Collantes. May I ask the ComSec to acknowledge guests present in person or via Zoom? ComSec?
Mr. Chairman, our guests for today's committee meeting are the following. Inside the conference room, from the Department of Education, we have Assistant Secretary Francis Cesar Bringas of the Assistant Secretary for Operations. We have also Ms. Ruby Chanda Crisostomo, the OIC Project Development Officer 4 of the DepEd's Bureau of Human Resource Development and Organizational Development. And also Mr. Vladimir Kitua, the chairperson of the Alliance of Concerned Teachers, and Mr. Benjo Basas from the national chairman of the Teachers Dignity Coalition. Via Zoom, Mr. Chairman, we have from the Department of Education, Dr. Cesar Mujica, the Chief of School Governance and Operations Division of the Division of Bacoor City. Dr. Los Osminia, the Chief Quality Assurance of the DepEd Region 4A Regional Office. And Dr. Danilo Ilagan, the Supervisor of Region 4A also, Regional Office. And Dr. Charlie Salve, the Principal of Cebu City Science High School. From the Civil Service Commission, we have Director Sheila Cunha from the Human Resources Policies and Standard Office. From the Department of Finance, Mr. Rafael Andres, Department of Justice. We have Attorney Janeline Bicolora, the State Council. From the EDCOM 2 or the second EDCOM 2 Secretariat, Attorney Joseph Noel Estrada, the Chief Legal Counsel. From the Alliance of Concerned Teachers, Ms. Marvin Joy Tesorero of ACNCR. From the National Head Teachers Associations of the Philippines, Mr. Dino Bosili, its president. And from the Narvacan National Central High School Robotics Team. That would be all for now, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, COMSEC. Next matter in our agenda will be the consideration approval of the minutes of the committee meeting held on Feb 21, 2023. COMSEC, has the committee distributed the minutes of this meeting to all members at the appropriate time?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, the committee has provided each member of this committee with a copy each through the email.
Sir Chair?
Yes, Honorable.
May I move to dispense with the reading of the minutes since every member have already have the copy prior to our meeting and approve the same, Sir Chair.
Second.
There's a motion by the Honorable Franz Castro, really sent by the Honorable Joey Salceda, that we dispense with the reading of the minutes of the committee meeting held on Feb 21, 2023, and we approve the same. Is there any objection? Chair hearing none, same is approved. With this, we now move to the... proceed with the next matter on the agenda, which is the consideration and approval of the substitute bill on the Teaching Career Progression Act. Substitute bill on House Bills number 1580-3554, an act institutionalizing the career progression system for public school teachers. With this, with the permission of the members, we have discussed this already, but let me again... outline what has transpired in the past few committee meetings. First, currently, the setup for the Department of Education, and this can be confirmed or contradicted by any member from the any representative from the Department of Education. Under the current setup for career progression, we have everyone starts as teacher one, so teacher one, teacher two, teacher three. After teacher three, the person now has to choose whether he or she will choose the classroom teaching career line or the school administration career line. If classroom teaching career line is chosen, the next step is master teacher one. But we were also we found out during this committee meetings that before one becomes a master teacher one, it is not sufficient that that person is competent. Included in the criteria is that there are at least six teacher three individuals for that particular subject. Second, if one will now choose the other path, the school administration career line, the first step could be the head teacher one. This usually happens for those small schools in school divisions offices wherein there will not be a career path. So wala talagang principal na pumapasok dyan. So nagiging head teacher one, head teacher two, head teacher three, head teacher four, head teacher five, which is equivalent to an assistant school principal one, head teacher six, which is equivalent to an assistant school principal two, principal one, assistant then, assistant school principal three, school principal two, school principal three, and school principal four. Under the proposed bill, what we intend to do, and that was agreed upon during most of the all of the meetings in this committee and informal meetings, that we will now revise this career progression for our teachers. First, what we want to ensure is that our teachers will have the right to become teachers for life. And their salaries will be equivalent to our school principals. Second, hindi na po natin papayagan na hindi based on competence ng isang teacher. Tatanggalin na natin yung requirement ng quota system na kailangan na merong anim na teacher bago ka pa-promote. The Constitution is very clear. Access to quality education. So we must do that. So what we will do under the proposed legislation bill is that we will have teacher 1, teacher 2, teacher 3. The new items will be teacher 4, 5, 6, and 7. After that, master teacher 1. So yun yung basic. Teacher 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and master teacher 1. Lahat dadaan dun. Pagkatapos ng master teacher 1, doon na pipili kung ano yung career path mo. Kung magiging teaching career ka o magiging administration career ka. Kung pipiliin mo maging teacher career line, ang next mo after master teacher 1 will be master teacher 2, 3, 4, 5. Ang bago lang naman dyan, yung new item done will be master teacher 5. Because currently meron naman master teacher 4. Pero ngayon, gagawin na natin hanggang master teacher 5. Pag pinili mo yung admin career line, magiging principal 1 ka, which is the equivalent, ang equivalent nun, yung sweldo, magkapantay na sweldo, will be a master teacher 2 and a principal 1. Then a master teacher 3 with a principal 2. Master teacher 4, principal teacher 3. And master teacher 5, principal 4. Yan na po yung pinakamataas for both. Career lines. Gusto lang natin po masigurado. Yung gusto magturo ng matagal at magaling naman magturo, talagang maayos, ay manatili sa choice niya na nagtuturo siya habang yung sweldo niya sumasabay paangat. Hindi katulad ngayon, pag hindi siya nag-school principal line, hindi po siya makakakuha ng angat sa sweldo niya. Ngayon, during these hearings, nagkaroon ng issue tungkol sa merong mga head teacher na kasalukuyan. Base po dun sa unang hearing po natin, ang lumabas po dun ay meron tayong about 3,000 lang na, 3 to 4,000 na head teachers. Pero subsequent hearings in this committee and outside this committee, yung mga informal meetings, lumalabas pala na napakarami yung head teachers natin. Umaabot po yan ng almost 20,000 or a little more than 20,000. Ang problema po, yung head teachers po natin, napasok po dyan sa pagiging head teacher kasi nga medyo naipit sila sa progression. Kailangan may school principal na yung paaralan, pero since maliit yung paaralan, hindi siya shoot under the guidelines ng DBM and DepEd. So napwersa sila mag-head teacher muna. So medyo iniiwan na nila yung teaching nila. Pagka hindi po natin iayos sa yung head teachers ngayon, ang mangyayari po dito ay kawawa sila. They will lose benefits. So ang proposal po natin under the current bill rin, binibigyan po natin ng isang taon yung mga head teachers na kasalukuyan. Pumili sila in one year, within one year, kung magpapa-reclassify sila o retitle. Kung hindi sila magpapa-reclassify o retitle, ang piliin nila, ipagpapatuloy nila yung progression nila currently. Kasi meron na po eh. We don't have to write that into the bill because it is currently the practice. It is now under the DBM and DepEd na meron na rin career progression ngayon. Magpapatuloy sila as head teacher 1 with the salary grade that they get, head teacher 2, head teacher 3, head teacher 4, head teacher 5, pareho na ng school principal yon, at patungo po sa magiging school principal 4. Hindi po natin gagalawin, hindi mababawasan ang benefits nila. The bill is very clear. They have one year to choose. Pag pinili nila head teacher, mananatili sila with all their benefits as head teacher patungong school principal. Pangalawa po, equally important po dito, no? And I think dito po natin kailangan yung tulong ng ating mga ibang teacher organizations, DepEd, at yung mga members po na interesado. Ang gagawin din po natin dito ay magi-establish na po tayo ng third party assessment. Gusto po natin na maliwanag na yung promotions and career progression will have to be based on merit and performance, and that merit and performance will be judged by a third party. Kasi napakahirap po kung DepEd rin po ang gagawa niyan. Kasi sa totoo po, masyado rin po yung pressure pag sila rin na nagpatuloy niyan. Ibibigay po natin sa third party po yan para maliwanag, maayos po. Kailangan po, ang criteria po dyan, again, ito yung pwede natin mapag-usapan ngayon, base dun sa resulta ng PISA examination at ng pag-aaral ng World Bank sa PISA results, ang lumalabas po ay yung mga teachers po natin na dumiretso po sa career nila bilang sa teacher education ay mas maganda pa po yung performance ng mga estudyante sa ilalim ng mga nandun sa mga subjects po na hindi teacher education. So hindi content-based. Kaya siguro yung assessment should really be majority po should be on the content-based, hindi yung pedagogical. Kasi yun naman po ang hinahanap natin eh, yung quality of education. Again po, nandito rin po yan sa bill. But again, before we pass, there may be suggestions on that particular matter. Siguro po, no, sa kahulihan ito, before we approve this bill today, we will have some amendments to the substitute measure. Kasi hindi po express eh, yung pagkasulat na dapat ang promotion ng teacher ay based on merit, fitness, and competence after a comprehensive performance assessment. Natural vacancy, quota, ratio, and proportion, and the like shall no longer be considered or be the basis for promoting teachers. We will expressly put that in this bill. Para competency-based talaga po ang gagawin natin. Marahil po, lahat naman tayo inaabangan nito at gusto natin matagal na po natin pinag-uusapan to, hindi lang may itong kongresong ito. At siguro, panghuli ko nang babanggitin, yung isang mahalaga rin po dito sa batas na ito, yung salary grade ng bawat teacher ngayon, ang starting na po niya, hindi na po salary grade 11, salary grade 12. If you will recall, kasama po natin ang DBM dito nung isang meeting tungkol sa bagay na ito. Ang sinabi sa atin ng DBM, nakalkula na rin po nila kung ano yung pangangailangan para ma-increase natin to salary grade 12, salary grade 13, 14, and 15. Pag in-increase natin ng one notch, initially ang kailangan 29 billion and that was submitted to us by the DBM. On record na po yan. So we even know the amount. So with that, I hope we get the cooperation of all members para makita rin po ng mga guro kung sino talaga ang sumusuporta sa kanila. At sino po yung lip service lamang. Let's open now for any questions from any member. Kung wala muna, umpisa na muna natin dito sa ating mga bisita. From the Department of Education, sino po ang magsasalita?
Your Honor, Assistant Secretary Francis Cesar Bringas.
Yes, Bringas, yes, you have the floor.
Thank you, Your Honor. With me are the representatives from the Bureau of Human Resource and Organizational Development who are in charge of the career progression, which is the policy on the career progression in compliance with...
Matagal na po natin pinag-uusapan ito, hindi lang may itong Congress.
Bureau of Human Resource and Organizational... Yeah.
Yes,
Secretary, Your Honor. And they are in charge of the draft policy on the implementation of Executive Order 174 signed by then President Duterte last June 2022, which speaks of the progression from teacher 1 to teacher 7, master teacher 1 to master teacher 5. And in the department, we currently have a draft policy for its implementation. And we also have the new merit selection plan, which is approved also pending implementation this year, first quarter, hopefully. But we do have comments on the part where the promotion will be handled by a third party system, and our focal person from the BHROD will expound on this matter, if you allow, Your Honor.
Please state your name and your position sa Department of Education.
Yes, good afternoon, Your Honor. I'm Ruby Chanda Crisostomo po. I'm OIC, Assistant Chief for Human Resource Development Division. We appreciate, Your Honor, the substitute bill on the career progression as it's already aligned with the direction of the department on the expanded career progression system as mentioned in the Executive Order 174. Except that we have comments on the promotion of teachers. We already have a draft policy on teacher promotion, which is already anchored on the professional standards, Philippine Professional Standards for Teachers, the PPST, wherein we would like to, we are already draft upholding policy on teacher promotion, which is already upholding the principles of merit, fitness, and competence as mentioned in our merit selection plan. We also support the independent party, the independent third party, but we would like to propose that this be applied for a teacher accreditation system wherein we can really assess our teachers whether they are beginning, proficient, highly proficient, and distinguished for purposes of teacher accreditation, but not necessarily for promotion for from teacher 1 to 2 or 2 to 3 and so on and so forth.
So how do you propose po? Paano niyo ipropromote? Kasi alam niyo po yung problema ko sa ano ninyo and problema ng many members that I have talked to. Yung progression po from teacher 1, teacher 2, alam niyo po ginagawa ninyo, di ba? Ang part po ng requirement ninyo, una, kailangan nag-MA. Kung hindi man nag-MA, may certain number of units. Pag binasa niyo po yung report ng World Bank tungkol sa teachers, tungkol sa PISA examination, isa po sa nakalagay po doon, ang Pilipinas po, bemedaled yung ating teachers. Ang highest po na professional development ay mga teachers po sa Pilipinas. Yun po yung resulta ng PISA examination based on interviews and based on the documents submitted them. But we know kung ano yung results po natin ng students natin. Di ba po? So again po, if that will not be the basis for promotion, uulitin lang po natin yung sinasabi po ninyo. Pipilitin niyo po muli yung mga teachers. Alam niyo po ginagawa nila. Pipilitin niyo po sila na kumuha ng mga online courses o kung ano man ang courses para lang ma-promote. Eh, paano po yun? Hindi po, that may not, and it has shown in the past, it did not promote quality. Unless po mali ako, no? you can correct us anytime. Wala naman akong problema. Pero yun lang yung nakita ko sa report ng World Bank based on their exit interview ng PISA examination results. Ang mga teacher po natin, kailangan mag-masteral para napopromote sila po, di ba? Pero yung results po sa PISA, hindi rin po ganun kaganda. So, hindi ba po ang titingnan po dapat natin sa promotion should be based on not on that matter po? Kasi sabi nga ng teachers po natin, sabi rin sa ano, ito rin yung isang pinuno sa World Bank report. Kung titingnan po ninyo, I'm sure na ba, nakita niyo na yun. Ang isa pang sinabi, napakahirap po ng pinapadaan natin sa teachers. We require them 5 to 6 hours a day of teaching. Hindi pa po yun. Tayo pa ang pinakamaraming subject sa lahat ng mga bansa. Pero yung results po natin, ito pa rin. That is why we wanted sana talagang ayusin na po natin. Kasi yung pag-uusap naman ng access, eh, madali naman po yun. Talagang it's a function of funding eh. Pero yung quality na po, ang doon na po tayo patungo. Yun lang ang gusto namin pag-usapan. And quality po necessitates our discussion on teacher promotion. So paano niyo po gagawin? Pareho pa rin ang proposal niyo ng teacher promotion?
Mr. Chair, under the proposed policy for the progression of teachers is not really about promotion but more on reclassification based on the merits of individual teacher. Wala na po tayong ranking against other teachers because it is purely based on the professional standards for teachers, which contains in part several indicators of the competence and skills of expected of a teacher 1, teacher 2, teacher 3, teacher 4, and so on. So it's no longer based on education. In fact, in the new guidelines, we have already provided lesser point system for education, unlike before where we go up to or 20. Now it's only up to 10 because we recognize what you have observed, that the presence or the attainment of a higher level of education does not really equate to a better quality of teaching. So we are giving more premium on trainings and their performance in under the indicators of the results perform management system, Your Honor.
It brings us nabanggit na training. Again, that would be the same. What do you mean by training? Training po, again, no? Again po, the observation of some other studies is napakarami rin nating training na binibigay. Kaysa magturo yung teacher, nauubos yung oras niya, nag-a-attend ng either online po, no? Again, wala akong problema sa training, ano? Pero then again, yun yung issue eh. And we just want to correct this. Gusto natin bawasan subjects. Gusto natin bawasan ang load ng teachers. Gusto natin... Ang ginagawa lang po nila talagang naka-focus sa pagtuturo. Pero nabanggit kayo po nagbanggit training. So ano na naman tong training na ito?
Your Honor, we have the National Educators Academy of the Philippines under the HROD as well. And ongoing now is the transformation of the NAEP so that all trainings must be aligned with the requirements of the Philippine Professional Standards for Teachers. So all trainings that will be conducted or that will be attended by teachers must be accredited by the National Educators Academy to make sure that these are aligned with the professional standards for teachers. So that would be for the NAEP. And for the number of subjects that you mentioned, Your Honor, the curriculum and teaching strand of the department is currently reviewing and revising the K-12 curriculum. We are starting with the key stage one, that is kinder up to grade 3, and we are looking into the direction of really minimizing the number of subjects for the key stage one, Your Honor.
Asik, bring us, ano, baka, just to enlighten us, ano, when you talk about yung training sa NAEP, in fact, this last Congress, tayo po under the Excellence in Education, Teachers Education Act, tayo po nag-institutionalize nung NAEP, if you recall. Kung maalala po natin, ang basis dapat ng NAEP is upskilling. And kunyari, yung binanggit po ninyo kanina, yung medyo hindi up to par, yun yung sinasabi ninyong magkaka-training. So, hindi magiging requirement na mag-training ka para ma-promote. Hindi ganun. May assessment muna bago mag-training. Is that correct?
Yes, exactly, Your Honor. So there is going to be a competency assessment of all the teachers so that on the basis of the results of this assessment will be the training that each teacher needs to undergo so that the quality of teaching will improve.
Yes. With that, ano, sa akin po, ano, of course, the members will ask you questions, I'm sure. Sa akin na po, i-submit it to us. We can pass this morning subject to that amendment. Now, with respect to teacher promotion, we will that may be considered together with the third party.
Yes, Your Honor, our position is for the third party, independent third party, to be part of the accreditation of the different levels of proficiency, but the promotion itself will remain as they are provided also in the ORA, that is for the civil service, and requiring each agency to have their own human resource and a merit and promotion system in compliance with the ORA, Your Honor.
Which will no longer be based on academic background, meaning yung mga MA nila and doctorate, which will no longer be based on the number of trainings or seminars that they attend before they are promoted. Is that correct?
It is largely based on their compliance to the Philippine professional standards for teachers, Your Honor.
Yes. When you say largely, parang may palusot na...
Oh, yes. Of course, Your Honor, there are positions in the department that will also require a master's degree. Like, for example, a supervisor must have a master's degree, things like those. But for teachers, they will not. A master's degree is definitely not a requirement. But all others equal, it will provide an edge to a particular applicant. But then, it's no longer a competitive promotion, Your Honor. Under the PPST, it is largely based on your own merits as a teacher, according to the indicators in the PPST.
Sige. Salamat, Asik Bringas. But I'm sure members, Honorable Congressman Franz, before I recognize you, could I also acknowledge the presence first in person with us this morning, the gentleman from the Lone District of Sarangani, the Honorable Steve Solon. The Solon. From the Lone District of Calamba City, the Honorable Charisse Ann C. Hernandez Alcantara. From the GP Party List, the Honorable Jose Gigi Padiernos. From the gentleman from the 2nd District of Agusan del Sur, the Honorable Edibong G. Plaza. And from the 6th District of Negros Occidental, the Honorable Mercedes K. Alvarez. Honorable Castro, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Magandang umaga po sa ating mga colleagues at syempre sa ating mga resource person. Maganda po, Mr. Chair, ano yung sinabi ni ASEC Bringas, no? That the teachers will not compete with each other. The promotion will be based on merits and performance of the teachers. So available na ba, Mr. Chair, yung ano sinasabi nilang guidelines for promotion? So can we get the copy? Kasi parang last time pa natin inaano yun eh, wala pang binibigay na copy.
Yes, we can share the committee a copy of the policy, draft policy. It's pending review, Your Honor, and prior to release.
So, Bringas, okay. Please provide the committee and bigyan mo na rin si ano, yung ating mga katabi. Kasi yes. kailangan po namin yung comments rin nila because we want this talagang ano eh, all stakeholders will have a say. Yes, Honorable Francis.
So, these guidelines on professional standards for teachers, ito po ba ay ano, hiwalay po yung guidelines for evaluating master teacher, from teacher 1 to master teacher 5, and also with the administration career path. Iba po yung guidelines.
Your Honor, we have a Philippine Professional Standards for Teachers and we also have Philippine Professional Standards for School Heads.
Okay, so may hiwalay sila.
Yeah. That is already a framework that has been institutionalized by the department and we will be glad to provide you a copy of that framework.
Thank you po, Mr. Chair. Kasi nakalagay kasi dito sa bill natin, sa promotion, dapat yung mga teachers ay doon sa kanyang subject area siya, i-evaluate. So ibig sabihin nun, binaban natin dito yung pag-assign sa mga teachers sa ibang subject area nila. Like for example, Mr. Chair, nabanggit ko na rin ito eh, maraming teachers na umaangal na sa ibang probinsya. Alam ba, teacher siya ng English, pagtuturuin siya ng AP, pagtuturuin siya ng ibang subject. So hindi niya ngayon magagamit yung experience niya dahil ang major niya, halimbawa ay English or mathematics, magtuturo ng MAPE. So wala nang dapat na ganun, ano? Dapat yung mga teachers talaga natin ay kung ano yung subject area, doon talaga siya magpakagaling at doon na dapat na ituro niya. Kasi mawawalan na siya ng ano, Mr. Chair, ano, mawawalan siya ng opportunity dito sa promotion na yon kapag ginawa po yan ng DepEd. So ma-ensure po ba yan dun sa guidelines, Mr. Chair?
Mr. Chair, the PPST and the PPST is not based on the ability or competency of the teacher for a certain subject area, but it is in general the competency of a teacher. So hindi na discriminate dun sa PPST kung ikaw ay major in science, English, or anything, but it is in general, Mr. Chair. So kasi that those are indicators of the competence of a classroom teacher, not necessarily a specific subject area.
Mr. Chair, ating nilagay dito na dapat subject area yung...
Yes, pero Congresswoman Franz, we can adjust that. Ang question ko naman ganito, paano kung kulang talaga ang guro? Hindi enough yung teachers. That is why, in a way, yes, kailangan talagang mapakiusapan na magturo dun. Kasi kung hindi, yung core subjects na mandated, hindi matuturo.
Pwede naman yung Mr. Chair. Kaya lang, wag dapat i-discriminate. Ibig sabihin, i-count pa rin, Mr. Chair, yung experience ng teacher na kahit na math major siya, nagturo siya for how many years, halimbawa ng MAPE or English, i-count pa rin yun. Kasi ang ginagawa na naririnig ko sa mga teacher ay hindi yon. Tama po ba? Kasi parang yun ang ginagawa doon sa promotion eh.
Yeah, Mr. Chair, we can consider that. But just to let the committee know the subject area of specialization is used for deployment purposes, particularly in the secondary, junior high school, and senior high school. Because in the elementary, we all have generalists. And in the higher and the teacher education institutions, they don't really offer like a Bachelor of Elementary Education major in science or things like those. They are all generalists, except for the Bachelor in Secondary Education. That is why we are looking at the scarcity of some subject area specializations in the junior high school and senior high school. That is why we are forced to offer our teachers to teach certain subject areas that are not within their area of specializations.
Yes, Sir Chair, alam ko naman yun eh, generalist naman ng elementary, but I am talking of is the secondary, yung junior and senior. Kasi Sir Chair, alam naman natin eh, may mga specialization sa high school na alam ba, sa math. Alam ko nagkukulang ng teacher sa mathematics, 'di ba? So minsan mayroong teacher tayo na from English pwedeng magturo ng mathematics. Ang point ko lang, Mr. Chair, mai-consider 'yun ano, doon sa promotion and merit system ng department, yung ginagawa ng department na guidelines. And another point, Mr. Chair, siguro sa DBM na 'to, no, doon sa paglalagay ng enough items. Kahit nga, Mr. Chair, meron tayong, halimbawa, we create teacher 4, 5 to 7, then master teacher 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Kung hindi rin mag-create ang DBM ng enough item for them, so madedefeat yung purpose natin. Kaya kailangan sa DBM, provide sufficient number of master teacher items and also the other positions.
Mr. Chair, I agree with that because in the current practice of the department for reclassification of teachers, we are really dependent on the availability of funds for reclassification. It's usually a one-time availability for reclassification of teachers funds for annually. So we would want that DBM would give the Department of Education more funds for reclassification because that is going to be the direction of the department when it comes to upgrading the salaries or career progression for teachers. So we would be requiring additional funds, particularly that we will be up to teacher 7 and master teacher 5, which has a lot of financial implications, Your Honor.
Thank you, Asik Bigas. Congressman Franz, nandun yung sa section 5, last paragraph natin. In fact, the last sentence of that last paragraph, you'll see it in line, starting in line from line 48 up to the next page. The Department of Budget and Management, DBM, shall create the new teaching position titles of Teacher 4, Teacher 5, Teacher 6, Teacher 7, and Master Teacher 5, and include the same in the Index of Occupational Services, Occupational Groups, Classes, and Salary Grades. Unless kulang po ito, again, we are okay. May ma-improve ito. Just give us.
Chair. Yes, mag-create nga po ng item.
Oh, oh.
So what I am pointing, Mr. Chair, yung mag-ano sila ng enough position. Kasi tanungin natin ng DBM, ilan ba yung available nationwide na position for Master Teacher 1? Yes. Ilan ba ang kinreate nila? Ilan ba yung kinreate nila for Master Teacher 2? Mabibilang mo yan, wala pa yatang hundreds yan, Mr. Chair. Ngayon, maglalagay tayo ng Master Teacher 3, 4, 5. Baka naman ibig sabihin, baka kukunti lang yung makreate. So, yung sinasabi ng Department of Education na they will promote according to merit performance at hindi ito magiging competition among teachers, madi-defeat kapag konti lang po yung, ano, yung items na makikreate.
So, we should include this, we should amend the Section 5, the last paragraph, to ensure that the sufficient number of... Yes, sige. Ang gagawin natin, Honorable Castro, under Section
12...
Section 12, availability of additional items for promotion of teachers. The DBM shall ensure the availability of additional items for the promotion of teachers and the appropriate allocation of funds and inclusion in the general appropriations for its immediate implementation. Siguro itong sa Section 12, doon natin i-tweak kung kinakailangan para masigurado na yung concern po ninyo at ng DepEd ay masigurado natin. Sa Section 12 po, Section 12, page 4, Section 12, can ask Bringas, Ma'am France, can you take a look? But while you're taking a look at that, may I also welcome in this committee meeting in person, the Honorable Marisa Magsino from the OFW Party List. Magandang umaga po, ma'am.
Magandang umaga, Mr. Chair.
Marisa, and also on Zoom, from the 5th District of Leyte, the Honorable Carl Nicolas Cari. From the Lone District of Benguet, the Honorable Eric Goyap. From the Lone District of Nueva Vizcaya, the Honorable Luisa Loren Quaresma. And from the Lone District of Occidental Mindoro, the Honorable Yodi F. Tariela. Honorable Castro, Asik Bringas.
Yes, Mr. Chair, I would just like to point out, if I may.
Yes, po.
We distinguish between promotion and reclassification, because in Section 5, if you say create, it means it's a new item that is going to be created by DBM. But under the career progression that we are proposing here, it's reclassification, meaning there's no need to create a new item, but to reclassify the existing item occupied by a teacher into a higher position. So if a teacher one applies for reclassification, the same item will be converted to teacher two. So not necessarily a creation of a new item. That is further reclassification, Your Honor.
Yes. So saan natin kailangan ilagay po yung amend yung provision na yan o sentence na yan para masigurado po natin na covered yung concerns ni Congresswoman Franz Castro at ng Department of Education? Saan po natin, and could you propose some wordings para hindi na po tayo paligoy-ligoy? Diretso na po natin.
Siguro dun sa Section 10, Your Honor, instead of saying promotion of teachers, baka mas magandang reclassification.
Sige.
That it is consistent with the terms being used by the DBM.
Okay. We will do that, Asik Bringas. We will consider that. And ano naman eh, ang gusto lang naman natin, masigurado na covered natin yung mga iba-ibang concerns. So, instead of promotion?
Yes, sir. Although, Your Honor, I don't know if this will have an effect on the promotion of teachers due to existing vacant positions. For example, if a teacher 5 retires, so under the policy, is there going to be a promotion of a teacher 4 to teacher 5? Or I think part of our proposal is to convert the teacher 5 into teacher 1. Position instead. So wala na kaming promotion na pag nagbakante ang teacher 5, hindi na siya bakante as pipil upan ng mga galing ng teacher 4, pero automatic magko-convert yan to teacher 1, and then we'll have fund for another reclassification for teacher 5.
Asik Bringas, hindi ba yung main thrust po natin dito is really to focus on quality? So even yung mga promotions natin should be based on that. Because kayo nga nagsabi sa amin, meron kayong bagong regulation on that. Sabi nga natin, bawal na yung quota system na kailangan maghintay muna ng 6 na teacher sa isang subject bago magkaroon ng Master Teacher 1. Kung walang, kahit walang 6, pero competent na yung teacher, that teacher must be promoted to Master Teacher 1.
Yes, Your Honor, we support that. Because in the current practice, in the elementary, 10% of the total number of teachers per district, that would be the total number of master teachers created by or allowed by the Department of Budget and Management. Where the secondary, at least for every 6 teachers, 1 master teacher for each subject area. So we would support a provision in the bill that would eliminate the quota system.
Talaga, let's focus on quality talaga so that we can really bring to life the constitutional requirement of access to quality education. May I also acknowledge the presence over Zoom of the Honorable Paolo Duterte from the 1st District of Davao City. Any more comments from the ACT Teacher Party List or from the Teachers Dignity Coalition? Unahin natin si Vladimir, Sir Vladimir.
Magandang umaga, Mr. Chair. Vladimir Ketua po from Alliance for Some Teachers Philippines po. Iba po yung ACT Teachers pa.
Po, sorry.
Sige po, magandang magandang umaga sa lahat po at sa ating mga kinatawan na nandito at sa ating kasama sa DepEd at sa aking kasama sa TDC. No? May ilan lang kaming mga mungkahi sa usapin po ng papapatupad ng career teacher progressions, no? In fact, ay sinasalubong namin yung ganitong pagtingin dahil sa matagal na panahon ay talaga namang may ilang mga distortions o usapin ng salary, no? Pagdating ng teacher 3, wala nang patutungan ng teacher is either magmaster teacher na lang to, no? Kaya mayroon kami ilang mungkahi na tabanggit naman na kanina, una ay dapat ay maging reasonable, no? At abot kamay at dapat nga nakabatay dun sa quality at isang guidelines at qualification standard po para dun sa pagkakaroon ng promotions, no? Sa buong bansa, kasi sa matagal na panahon, pag tinanong mo ilang mga regions, magkakaiba sila, no? So sana dito ay maayos na ito, no? Pangalawa ay dapat ang promotion ay batay dun sa actual na qualification ng guro at yung pagtatanggal ng binabanggit na natin kanina, no, na nakalilimit ang ladderized na promotion. Sa matagal na panahon din, ang teacher gusto magpa-promote from teacher 1 to master teacher 1 ay hindi ito nagaganap. Kailangan dumaan muna sa teacher 2 at teacher 3. So sana ay mawala na rin yun, no? Matlo, sana ang sistema ng promotion ay hindi nakadepende dun sa nabanggit naman na kanina, bakanting item, no? Kung kailan lang mababakante, kaya ang iba mga teacher ay nag-wish na sila ay mapunta na sa abroad, o kaya may mga mamatay pa para lang makuha nila. Namamasakit na katotohanan, no? So sana ay magkaroon, no? At salip ay sa pamamagitan ng pagreklas o upgrade ay nung sariling item na sa kasalukuyang inuukupan ng guro ay ma-promote yung dapat lahat ma-promote. Tanggalin yung limitasyon, no, sa ilalim, no, ng bilang ng master teachers. Kanina po nababanggit na yung 1:6 at may nabanggit na ay 10% sa bawat district. Pero sana sa tingin ng Alliance of Concerned Teachers, nabanggit na ni ating chair, sana talagang kung qualify naman talaga siyang maging master teacher ay maging master teacher na siya, no. Panglima, bigyan ng karapatang puntos, mas mataas sa puntos yung karanasan sa pagtuturo. Pangani, malino, magkaroon ng malinaw at makaturong ang plano po para sa mga head teachers na banggitan na ating chair, mayroon silang isang taon para sa kanilang pagre-reclass o pagre-retitle, no? At dapat po hindi sila madihado rito sa usapin po ng promotion. Pampito, mahalaga ito sa amin, laanan ng sapat na budget, no? Lalo na sa usapin ng mga personal services, sa usapin ng promotion at pagpapatupad po. Na dati ay tinatawag naming EO-174 pa ito, no? At siyempre, magkaroon ng kinatawan po sa ang mga guro sa pagkaroon ng IRR. At ang pinakamahalaga sa amin, pinakahuling bahagi po ay pag-isipan din, no, sa bill na ito, yung entry level, no, yung salary grade 15. Dahil tingin namin kung mananatili yung SG-12 o ito na yung magiging entry level, mabalik uli sa dating kagawian ng mga teacher, magtitinda ng panty, bra, longganisa, mag-online. Dahil napakababa po ng sahod, no? Napag-iwan na po ang sweldo ng guro sa usapin po ng nurse at ng mga kapwa namin pulis. Hindi po nakabubuhay ang sahod niyon ayon mismo sa datos ng gobyerno. At sa totoo lang po ay paniabono ang mga teacher. So sana pag-isipan yung huling binanggit ko, salary grade 15 po sana yung entry level. Yun lang po, maraming salamat.
So, Sir Vladimir, para maliwanag, you're opposing the passage of this bill na in-increase namin to salary grade 12. Ang gusto ninyo, either salary grade 15 o wala.
Sana po
ay maliwanag.
Opo, sana
po. Are you existing or not? Hindi sana po. Are you opposing or are you supporting?
Supporting the 12, opo, of course.
Second po, eksakto po sa bill na ito, lahat ng binanggit ninyo, ano yung nabanggit ninyo na wala pa dito? Kasi dapat ayusin na natin ngayon, eh. Kasi kung magtatagal na naman tayo, walang mangyayari. So sa lahat ng binanggit po ninyo, maging specific na po tayo. Ano dito sa current substitute measure na hindi nilalaman yung nabanggit po ninyo?
Siguro, Mr. Chair, yung amin lang siguro pagdating sa IRR. Pagdating na sa IRR.
Yung iba nandito naman?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay, good, good. Thank you. Pasensya na. Gusto ko lang kasi mapasa to as soon as we can. Eh. So hindi, wala na naman mangyayari. Yes, Sir Benjo, ikaw ba sunod?
Salamat, Mr. Chair. Magandang umaga po sa lahat ng members. Of course, sa DepEd at sa kaibigan ko, Sir Vlad. No? Dalawang reaction, no, if I may, Mr. Chair, no? Una doon sa pinag-uusapan natin na labas pa dito sa bill. No? Pero unahin ko po muna yung bill. No? Dito po kasi sa bill, medyo nagulat po kami, no? Dahil doon sa substitute version, no, na nilabas po ng committee noong November, ay specified po, no, na meron pa rin yung head teacher positions, ano po, no? Pero dito po sa binasa po sa for this hearing po ay wala na, no, wala na, no, well, Of course, napag-usapan natin, sir, no, during the informal meetings, no, as regards to this bill po, yung mga gayon, ano po. But of course, no, nanatili pa rin naman kami na umasa na baka hindi naman mawala, no, yung well, binanggit nyo naman po kung gaano ka-importante yung ating mga head teacher positions, no, dito sa Department of Education. Yeah.
Alam, maliwanag tayo. Pakibasa po natin yung Section 6 nitong substitute measure kasi baka magkaroon ng impresyon
okay,
na walang head teacher. Hindi po totoo yan. Liniliwanag ko po. Section 6. Options of incumbent head teachers.
Yes, sir.
So hindi sila mawawala kasi baka magkaroon ng misunderstanding sa statement po ninyo na sinasabi ninyo na may usapan na may head teachers ay mananatili. Mananatili po sila. Napakaliwanag po niyo sa Section 6. So please read for Section 6 bago tayo magpatuloy kasi baka ma-misinterpret. Pasensya na, Benjo, ha, talagang ayaw ko lang po na may misinterpretation, misunderstanding.
Yeah, yeah. Sir Chair, no, yes, I apologize for that, no, framing, no. Pero ang sinasabi naman po kasi dito, no, head teachers, no, will have options, no po, na maaari siyang maging coterminus, ano po, and for 1 year pwede siyang pumili. No. At least, no, yung head teachers na incumbent, no, for now ay mananatili. No, that's the understanding of the group, no. TDC, both TDC and the NATAP, the National Association of Head Teachers, ano po, no.
Medyo hindi pa maliwanag yun sa Section 6 na yung mga incumbent, yung mga ngayon na head teachers ay may choice sila, mananatili silang head teacher. The career progression that they have right now will continue. Kung hindi maliwanag yun in your reading, Benjo, sabi mo sa amin kung ano dito hindi maliwanag para revise na natin agad-agad.
Sir, well, hindi po kami sa ganung framework, sir, no. Of course, first, I would like to clarify that we do not oppose, no, the idea of career progression. In fact, like, dun sa mga second sa bill talaga ay after, no, after a year or after these incumbents. In fact po, no, pag hinarmonize natin siya doon sa draft, no, nung DepEd po, no, ay sa DepEd gayon din, no, mukhang sa DepEd nga po ay hanggang magkaroon ng natural vacancy, no, doon sa draft po, no, doon sa draft IRR po 174. The good thing about this career progression po policy po ay well, you have, no, the committee has this proposal po, no, kaya siguro nahihirapan din ng DepEd maglabas, no, IRR po 174, no, parang naipit din, no? Dahil baka mauna yung Congress, eh magiging irrelevant naman po, no. But sir, kami yun lang po, no, yung aming gustong sabihin, ano. Anyway,
Benjo, para maliwanag, yung head teachers na kasalukuyan ngayon, head teachers, again, if they choose to remain as head teachers, that progression, magko-continue po yun.
Opa.
Until they retire.
Yes, yes.
See, 1 year po yun. Yung 1 year lang po, yung option to choose.
Option to choose. Yeah.
If they choose to be head teachers, yung kasalukuyan, until they retire po,
opa,
that is the career path that they will have. So, hindi natin sila tinatanggal. In fact, may express statement dito na walang mababawasan dapat na benefits, emoluments, or whatever po sa kasalukuyan po. Kasi base po 'yan sa meeting po natin, in fact.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Opo.
Yeah, of course, no, yung non-diminution naman po ay principle, legal principle naman po, na even the Supreme Court po merong decision po diyan, no. But sir, siguro baka yung kasama ko po na nasa Zoom later ay magbibigay po ng statement, no. Pero puntahan ko lang po yung binanggit ng aking kaibigan na si Sir Vlad, no, yung salary grade 12. Sana po yung salary grade, of course, no, we appreciate, no. Sabi ko nga po, no, doon sa mga nakaraan naming mga statement, sabi namin kahit piso ang idagdag, no, na sweldo sa mga teacher, ay ibig sabihin yan ay ano, yan ay patunay, no, that the government, no, recognizes the need, no, for an additional salary, no, for our teachers, kahit piso, no? Pero wag naman piso, no? pero po, no, at least yung salary grade 11, salary grade 12, no? Ang haba nito, sir, no? Kasi 1989 nag-upgrade yung teacher 1, no, yung entry level to salary grade 11, no, nung 2009 lang. Ngayon po eh 2023, no, kung mag-upgrade kami to 12, kailan po to? The another 20 years pa po ito siguro, no, bago maging salary grade 13. Sana lang po, no, siguro pareho kami ng sentiment, no, ni Sir Vlad, no. Siguro wag sana ito maging ano, no, wag sana itong maging hadlang, no, kasi I understand po, no, our friends legislators po, no, in both houses, no, ay meron pong mga proposals, no, na salary grade 15, 16, 17 up to 22, no. Mukhang imposible naman 'yon, ano po, no, yung entry level, ano po. And then meron din tayong tinatawag po na additional support and compensation for teachers. Yan yung tinatawag po namin sa language namin na 10,000 across the board. Sana po ay kahit meron na tayo nito, no, kasi baka magkaroon ng justification. O kakabigay lang namin sa inyo, wag na natin pag-usapan yung salary. Kasi ngayon pa nga lamang po, no, ang existing salary po natin, yung SSL5, eh parang ayaw ng pag-usapan, no, yung salary increase proposals, no. Well, aside from this one, of course, kasi galing sa inyo to, no. Kaya ito mukhang pinag-uusapan na po ito, no. Salary grade 12 would be perhaps, no, appreciated, no. But salary grade 15 or 10,000 across the board would be more appreciated. Siyempre, no. Mas mataas po kasi, no. Tapos doon po, no, sir, para doon po sa bill, no. Doon po sa binabanggit po ninyo, no. Ang dami pong diploma mills, no. Baka pwede natin pong pag-usapan ito, no, in one of our future hearings po, no, na nag-o-offer ng napakaraming mga kurso, no, at ang gaganda pa ng mga pangalan nito. Of course, I wouldn't want to cite, no, a name, no, pero magaganda po, no, parang intergalactic pa nga yung dating ng iba, no po, no, yung mga title ng mga schools na nag-o-offer. Bakit po nagkalat ito, no? Kasi yun nga po, binanggit nyo na, no, exacto yun, Mr. Chair. Salamat po, no, for that, no. Kasi ang hirap naman talaga, no, sa kasalukuyan na ma-promote sa DepEd, no, kung ikaw ay walang studies, no. In fact, kapag meron kang studies po, meron kang papel, no, kahit hindi ka natuto, okay lang sa DepEd po yun, no. Yun yung medyo masakit po sa amin, ano po. Kahit hindi ka nagturo talaga, no, basta ikaw ay merong papel, no, na ikaw ay nag-aral, no, sa isang eskwelahan na kung ano man na nag-offer ng postgraduate studies, ay okay na yun po, no. So, mukhang kailangan po natin yung makita, no. Meron po kami doon sa aming ipinasa din po sa inyong tanggapan po, yung Teachers Dignity Agenda, no. Doon sa agenda number 11 po namin, sinasabi po namin yan, ano, yung pagtataguyod ng patas at makatarungang merit and promotion system sa Department of Education. Ano po? Isa po diyan na binabanggit namin, ano po, yung make the career progression accessible to all teachers with satisfactory performance, no, in a certain period of service. Pangalawa, provide free postgraduate studies for teachers. Wala po tayo nito. Doon po sa teacher quality education na law, no, meron pong binabanggit doon pero mukhang hindi pa priority, no, kasi free service, eh, no, yung mas binibigyan po doon ng priority, no. Pangatlo, sabi namin sa promotion po sana ay i-prioritize, no, yung mga teachers, yung seasoned teachers who serve in remote areas. No po, ito po kasi talaga yung walang tsansa na ma-promote ngayon sa Department of Education. Wala pong tsansa dahil hindi accessible ang postgraduate education studies po, no. Pero sila yung pinakamatsatsaga. Sila yung naglalakad sa mga bundok, tumatawid, sumasakay sa Alabao or whatever, ano po, no, para pumunta sa school. Pero never po mapo-promote ito sa uri po ng promotion system po natin ngayon sa Department of Education. And lastly, no, sana po, no, replace the complex and cumbersome results-based performance management system for teachers, ano po, yung RPMS, and restore the simple performance appraisal system for teachers, yung PAS na tinatawag po namin, no. Nag-teacher na po ako, pumasok ako sa DepEd 2002. 2023 na po ngayon. Medyo minsan umaalis ako sa DepEd pero bumabalik din po, no. Talagang pag first love mo, hindi mo talaga kayang iwan. Ano po? Pero 20 years na po, no? Ang punto lamang po dito, no? Siguro two decades ago po, mas maganda po yung performance ng ating mga bata at ng ating mga teacher. ano po, binabanggit po natin yan, nakita niyo po, ninyo yan. Pero ngayon, sa dami ng mga policies, no, para i-train yung mga teachers, para hingian na kung ano-anong requirements yung mga teachers, na kung ano-anong mga papel, na mga reports yung mga teacher po natin, ano, magsak yung quality of instruction. Simple lamang po, natumbok niyo kanina, Mr. Chair. Sa dami na kailangan gawin ng mga teacher, isa lang din niya nagawa. Hindi niya nagawa magturo. No? Yun lamang po, Mr. Chair, at maraming salamat po.
Thank you, Sir Benjo, Sir Vladimir, salamat po. No? Pero para maliwanag po, no? Under Section 6 ng ating substitute bill, yung incumbent head teachers po ay maproprotektahan po yung kanilang karera. Choice po nila yan. Yung diminution in ano, sabi nyo nga, no, legal, ano naman po yan, ipanggap na po yan sa law yan po, no, na dapat walang mawala. At pero kinaro rin po natin sa Section 9 yan. At sana maimbitahan ko po lahat na, again po, i-review yung Section 9. Baka mamaya meron kaming na-miss dyan na sentence o kulang. Ang gusto po natin, yung sinasabi rin ni Sir Benjo kanina, na masigurado natin kung ano man ang beneficyo, ano man ang nakukuha po ngayon, ay hindi maapektuhan yun. Tuloy-tuloy pa rin yun kahit na mag-i-increase tayo from salary grade 11 to salary grade 12. Ang sagot po namin yun, Section 9, pero baka kulang po ito. Wala kaming problema na improve to. Protektahan po natin kung ano man yung meron. Sir Vladimir, may gusto kong sabihin? Opo.
Yes, Mr. Chair. I don't know kung dito o baka sa IRR, no? Yung usapin at tinatanong ako ng mga teachers, paano kung magpa-ilipat siya? So, mabibit-bit ba niya yung salary grade niya o yung kanya level?
What do you mean malipat po?
Kunyari po, magpapalipat. Transfer po siya.
So, dapat po carry over lahat yun, di ba? I mean, it is still one Department of Education.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
This... Teka, ulitin natin. Ano yung benefits na pinag... Para maliwanag tayo.
Halimbawa po, siya po ay, dito, ay teacher 4 na po siya. Kung ma-promote na po siya, dapat bit-bit niya po yun kapag po ay siya ay nag-transfer.
Kunyari, ano po natin para kung yes, dito naman ang DepEd para mag-guide
kasi
tayo.
Sa mga tagal na panahon, Mr. Chair, katulad ko po, ako ay teacher ganito, bumaba po.
Teacher 1 po kayo kunyari.
Teacher 3, naging teacher 2, at marami pong ganyan po, Mr. Chair.
Ah,
at
hindi
po... malino na dito kung papasok dito sa Section 9.
Asik Bringas, pasensya na, no? Pwedeng maklaro sa members. Nangyayari po ba yan? Bali, pwede ka maging teacher 1 sa isang paaralan, tapos pag nalipat ka sa ibang... teacher 3 ka na, kunwari. Teacher 3 ka na sa isang paaralan. Pag nalipat ka sa ibang division's office, maging teacher 1 o teacher 2 ka ulit? Pwede po yun?
Your Honor, under existing guidelines, ang ating mga items kasi are plantilla-based. So if you, let's say for example, Division of Quezon City and then Division of Makati. If you are currently Teacher 3 in the Division of Quezon City and you wish to transfer to the Division of Makati, you will have to vacate your item in Quezon City and look and then request for a parallel or equivalent position in the Division of Makati in the absence of a Teacher 3, for example, at ang available ay Teacher 2 or Teacher 1, the transferee is given the option to accept the Teacher 2 or just stay in Quezon City as Teacher 3. But to carry the item, it is not permissible under existing guidelines because these are plantilla-based positions.
Will it be possible po for us to plug that gap somewhere in this bill? Kasi hindi ba gap po siya? Kung talagang gusto po natin i-promote ang quality, isipin po natin teacher 3 ka na, tapos para lumipat. Kunyari po, no? Assuming, sabi nga ni Sir Benjo kanina, iduduktong ko na lang, sabi niya kanina, ito yung point ni Sir Vladimir, no? Na nabanggit kanina ni Sir Benjo, paano po kunyari dito ka po nagtuturo sa NCR. Mas teacher 3 ka na. Eh nakita mo po, talagang gusto mong makatulong sa mga estudyante dun sa far-flung areas. Ibig sabihin po, para makaturo ka dun, kailangan mo ng, effectively po, no, I don't want to use the right, this term, pero para may demotion ka. So ikaw na nga po ang pupunta dun sa lugar na yon, may demotion ka pa. Hindi ba gap po yon? Hindi ba may problema po yon?
Yes.
Ay, hindi nyo kasalanan yun, ano? Pero
yes,
ganun ba talaga?
Mr. Chair, yan kasi yung sa plantilla kasi ng bawat division or bawat district, meron yung staffing complement that is dependent on on the size of the division or nasa plantilla na ina-allow ng DBM yung staffing complement. So that is also a way by which we can, or the department can also the equitable distribution of positions in the divisions. So kasi kung ia-allow natin na seamless ang transfer from one division to another, baka magkaroon ng exodus ng mga higher positions to one division, but I think there should be a little control over that.
Bringas, again, Asik Bringas, sorry. Asik Bringas, tama po kayo. Hindi natin sinasabi na pwede silang lumipat, magtumalon-talon kung saan nilang. Ang sinasabi natin, paano po kung talagang may pangangailangan, dapat po yung wording natin dito, kung may pangangailangan yung DepEd school doon sa isang lugar at lilipat po yung teacher doon, eh kung ang di ba ang phone number nga natin portable na eh. Hindi ba dapat madadala mo rin yung ano mo dun sa, hindi ko sinasabi na may choice ka po na ayoko na dito, lipat ako, hindi ganun. Pero paano kung kayo nagsabi, may pangangailangan tayo ng teacher dito sa isang lugar at yun ang lumipat yung teacher. Yun ang sinasabi kong, again, reasonable po yung sinasabi ni Sir Vladimir. Dapat portable yun, yung classification.
Mr. Chair.
O, tama po yun, Sir June.
Yeah.
But it can be subject eh. Because if it's subject to the availability of that current classification, we are not promoting quality. Ang sinasabi natin, dapat mag-create, pangangailangan yun eh. Hindi ba gano'n yun?
Mr. Chair, yes. Opo. Ang sinasabi po natin dito sa committee ng ating chair is kung may pangangailangan sa isang lugar para lumipat ang ating teacher, kung teacher 3 na siya at ang available lamang sa lugar na yon na paaralan na pupuntahan ay teacher 2. Meaning to say, it is not encouraging na teacher 3 ako, madedemote, sorry the word, pero parang demotion po ang dating noon. Will there be a possibility na kung teacher 3 ako, I can still hold on to my teacher 3 position kahit malipat ako dahil may pangangailangan, there's a need in this area, lalo na po sa mga far-flung places. Kasi kung bakit ako lilipat eh nandito na ako, ba't nyo ako ililipat? Di ba parang hindi maganda para isang teacher na tanggapin ang posisyon na masama ang loob niya na demotion that comes with the salary, Mr. Chair. Thank you po.
Asik Bringas, do you think anong point of view niya dito?
Yeah, Mr. Chair, dalawang perspectives. Yung DepEd ang nangangailangan at magta-transfer siya, definitely hindi yan demotion. Hindi ka o-offera ng mas mababa. But the perspective where the teacher voluntarily transfers to another division, kung ano yung available doon, yun yung pwede niyang i-occupy because we cannot dislodge a teacher who is currently holding a position. Pero kung need lang DepEd na i-transfer ka, we follow guidelines on transfers like sa Magna Carta kasi pwede kang mag-transfer or mag-detail in the exigency of the service for a maximum of 1 year. On the second year, kailangan may consent na yung teacher na i-detail mo. But for voluntary transfers, that's a different thing, Your Honor.
So tama po kayo, Asik Bringas, ano? And I think we will ask Sir Vladimir and Sir Benjo, no? Kung pangangailangan ng Department of Education, kung pangangailangan ng learner ng isang teacher 3 doon o master teacher 1 or teacher 4, 5, 6, yun naman sinasagot ng DepEd na hindi magkakaroon ng pagbaba ng kanyang classification. Ang sinasabi lang nila kung voluntary, hindi ba reasonable naman yun?
Mr. Chair, una-una po, hindi kasi talaga pwedeng gawin ng DepEd yun, no, on their own kasi po kami ay guarded po ng Magna Carta for Public School Teachers, no, which USEC ASEC cited here na promote pa, no? Malay natin. Anyway, hindi po pwedeng i-transfer yung teacher no, na wala siyang consent. No? So kapag kang action ay action po ng Department of Education, pwede kaming umangal. Ano po? Pwede namin i-contest. No? Medyo lengthy yung wordings po dyan ng Magna Carta. No? But iba po yung issue kapag gusto po naming mag-transfer. Kasi kung ano lang yung i-offer no, doon sa pupuntahan naming eskwela. Halimbawa po, kahit nag-transfer ka for a reason no, na valid talaga. Halimbawa po, lumipat ako ng tirahan. Ako'y taga Caloocan. Ano po? Ayoko na sa Caloocan, pumira na po ako sa, let's say, Norzagaray, Bulacan. Ano po, kung ano yung position, kahit master teacher po ako sa Caloocan, pagdipat ko sa Norzagaray, titignan po kung ano dalang available position doon. Kung teacher 1, teacher 1 po yan. Ang layo po niyan, that's salary grade 11 and salary 18 to salary grade 11. Kaya yung si, kung magsino po, parang totoo po yun, ano, na ito'y magiging demotion. Sa tingin namin, kinakailangan po, kasi naintindihan ko po yung DepEdro na pwedeng abusuhin po ito, no? Baka kasi madaling ma-promote dito sa isang lugar, 'di ba? Magpapa-promote muna ako tapos lilipat na ako, no? At pagpunta ko doon sa isang lugar naman, yun pa rin ang position ko, no? At naintindihan din po namin yung pupuntahan, no? Doon sa mga pupuntahan po kasi po na eskwelahan, nag-aaway-away sila doon sa position tapos biglang may dumating, dumating yung bago, eh siya kagad yung master teacher. Parang may ganun po. But of course, no, we really have po, no, to, kumbaga, to rationalize po, no, this policy. Kasi hindi naman po pwede na lahat ng lumilipat, nade-demote.
Sir. Pero kung voluntary, Sir Benjo, Sir Vladimir, para ano, usapang ano talaga to, ano, para lang we can move forward. Yung reasonable naman po yung rason ng DepEd in that sense, di ba? Reasonable yung kanila, pag may pangangailangan yung lugar, kailangan ng master teacher one, may lilipat, parang linipat mo po yan sa ano eh, sa isang parang yun mga last mile schools, pwedeng ganun, or kahit di last mile schools, yung medyo mas remote, or kahit pa paano pinalipat mo na probinsya, kasi yun po ayaw naman lumipat noon eh, sa batirahan niya. So yun, sinasagot naman ng DepEd, talagang hindi naman magkakaroon ng pagbaba nung kanyang classification. Ang sinasabi lang nila, dapat po talagang may isang kumukumpas. Ang kumukumpas po ng pangangailangan ng buong education sector natin, syempre yung Department of Education, kailangan naman ho, holistic yung approach. Kaya ang sinasabi nila, pag voluntary, yun yung ano, hindi ba for now reasonable naman po yun? Para we can move forward. Pasensya na po, ha, pero talagang, kasi ayoko rin, ano eh, again, baka mami, hindi pa natin mapasa. Sayang eh.
Yes, Mr. Chair, actually, involuntary naman eh. May mga hugot naman din ng mga teacher dyan. Banggit naman din ni Sir Benjo kanina yung usapin po ng tirad, yung usapin po ng pamilya. Pero dapat, hindi naman dapat din yung malayo. Ano? Halimbawa, kung teacher 3 na siya, babalik pa sa teacher 1. So sana ay mapag-isipan din sa kung sa papasok dito. No? Medyo malayo kasi, Mr. Chair, tinitinan namin na kahit voluntary, valid pa rin naman sa kanya yun. Ano? Yun yung kailangan pag-isipan.
So, siyempre po, kailangan base sa isang master plan.
Yes po.
Kasi po, kung hindi naman base sa isang master plan, ay pwede po talaga tayong magkagulo. Dahil kahit pa paano, kung hindi base sa master plan ng Department of Education, eh kahit pa paano, baka maging, pwede po talagang maging chaotic rin eh. Kung sabihin na natin voluntary para sa lahat. Yun lang naman. Reasonable naman yung, tayo naman, diretso tayo mag-usap eh. Pero kung reasonable naman yung patakaran nila, parang kahit hindi naman gusto natin sana na exceptions doon, ay siguro for now, baka pwede naman natin tanggapin yung reasonableness naman nung sinasabi nila. Kung okay rin po sa inyo, Sir Vladimir, Sir Benjo.
Yes, Mr. Chair, basta paki-ensure lang natin dun sa sinasabing una, kapag ang DepEd ang nag-atas, ay matiyak sana sa either maintain or ma-promote.
Yes. Sir Benjo, okay yun sa inyo? Sir Benjo?
Mr. Chair.
Yes, sir. No, yes, sir. I think hindi siya naman specifically provided, no, dito, yes, sa ating, yes, bill, po. No. And in fact, merong separate policy yung ating, no, Department, po, of Education. No, baka doon po kami mag-lobby, no.
Sige po.
Kung gusto nila kaming kausapin, no.
Kami gusto namin kayo kausapin, wala kaming problema diyan.
Hindi po.
Mr. Chair.
Gustong mag-usap niya.
Si kung gusto man Marisa.
Yes, Mr. Chair, this is very important po. Alam ko medyo controversial yung issue na ito. Ano po ba yung concept natin ng security of tenure in this case? Ito po, should the item attached to the holder unless removed for a valid reason? Nandun na po tayo. Can the item be simply transferred to the other division? Anyway, there's a funding naman po doon po sa ating funding sa GAA.
Yes, Honorable Marisa, mm-hmm, ang point ng Department of Education, sa ngayon po, yung patakaran, kunyari may pangangailangan talaga sa ibang divisions office, ay ina-accommodate po nila yon, parang nasesecond muna. So, hindi magkakaroon ng bawas sa promotion. Ang sinasabi lang ng Department of Education, hindi pa pwede yung lahat ng volunteers. Kasi kung ganun po, paano kung yung buong division po, mag-volunteer lumipat sa ibang lugar, pwede mo, yung pangangailangan naman po nung naiwan ay magkakaproblema sila. That is why ang gusto lang nila, it's based on a master plan.
Ang master plan na yon, isa lang naman talaga ang dapat magsabi nun, Department of Education. Sila yung may master plan, ito yung hugis po nung divisions natin, ito yung pangangailangan ng bawat division, dun po nila binabase. Naiintindihan naman natin lahat, maganda rin po, valid naman po yung voluntary sana. Ang problema, pag ginawa po natin yun, mukhang wala sa hugis ng master plan ng DepEd kung paano naman ang distribution po ng bawat teachers.
Okay, Mr. Chair, yung follow-up question ko lamang po is, like for example, 35 years ako naging teacher 3, napunta po ako voluntary doon sa isang lugar na naging teacher 2 ako, teacher 1. Pag nag-retire po ako, ano po ba ang masusunod doon? Yung 25 years or 30 years in service ko? O 3 years or 5 years or 10 years in service ko sa as teacher 2? Ano ang masusunod po ito doon sa ating retirement?
Asik Bringas?
I would advise the teacher, that particular teacher, 35 years in the service from one station teacher 3 to another station teacher 2. Upon arrival in the new station, apply for a classification for teacher 3. And then yung retirement niya computation will still be continuous ma'am. 35 and so on, yeah.
Very good. But that is
the difference would be the computation of the retirement benefit would be based on your salary for the past 3 years. So in the future, if siya magre-retire, yes, it will be computed as such.
So magkakawatan din.
Huwag sanang lumipat na lang, especially kung malapit ka na mag-retire, simply because sayang rin po yung pinaghirapan mo.
Sayang din yun.
Sayang talaga. So I think yung advice ng DepEd dyan na kung maaari, doon ka na muna dun sa until your retirement, dun sa mataas na classification mo. Pero kung talagang kinakailangan and you are willing to take that risk, when you transfer, immediately apply for reclassification. Opo, with that,
very well answered. Satisfied po, Mr. Chair.
Meron po pa bang gusto magtanong from Zoom? May nagtataas ba ng kamay?
Yes po. Comsec?
Your Honor?
Yes, Asik Bringas.
Just a comment here. If we go for, I have no objection to the salary grade 12, but this will create a domino effect on the higher positions in the bureaucracy. So if we have salary grade 12 for teacher 1, yung school principal 4 natin and master teacher 5 will be salary grade 23, which is already higher than the salary grade of an education program supervisor in the division and in the region. So I think we should look into how we can balance this. Siguro sa DBM ang mag-create ng bagong, I don't know, salary scale for so that hindi ma-disrupt yung current na scale natin. Thank you, Governor.
Hindi po namin, nung naimbitahan po natin yung DBM dito. In fact, I don't know who from DepEd was present during that meeting. Talagang alam po rin nila magkaka-domino effect. In fact, lahat po, hindi lang naman, lahat po mag-i-increase. Yun yung intindi ko. In fact, that's why ang binigay po sa atin na estimate ng DBM, if we increase yung teacher 1 ng 1 SG salary grade, lahat po yan maapektuhan. Hindi, ang intindi ko po lahat, yung buo maapektuhan lahat, hindi lang po yung re-classify natin ngayon or yung binigyan natin ng new teaching position. Lahat maapektuhan. That is why the amount given to this committee was 29 billion initially ang funding na kailangan. Malaki rin po talaga. But again po, Asik Bringas, because you have brought it up, we will make sure na yun yung tama yung understanding namin na yung amount na binigay sa amin ng DBM would not only cover po itong mga adjustments na ito but the whole Department of Education. Yun po yung intindi namin during that committee meeting. Yes, Asik Bringas.
That would be a great direction, Your Honor, because currently in our staffing, our EPS is salary grade 22. The next position is already a salary grade 24, that is a chief. So kung tataas lahat, yung 23 na bakante sa complement namin ngayon, malalagyan na.
Asik Bringas, we are not increasing the salary grade simply because although we think kailangan talaga, pero talagang pinipilit po namin itong gawin simply because talagang medyo nandito na tayo sa sitwasyon na kailangan mag-focus sa quality ng edukasyon. At talagang gusto natin, kasama na po nung pag-increase yan, yung sinasabi nyo kanina, kaya that is why very welcome sa amin, yung sinasabi po ninyo na yung pag-professionalize po talaga. Titingnan po namin yung sasubmit po ninyo kasi yung end of the day po, para sa learner lang po lahat ito. Gusto lang natin na, alam ko, kaka-PISA exam lang ba?
We are participating
This year,
when is December. The next? In 2 years next? Or 3 years?
3 years.
Sige, gusto po natin, itong susunod po na ito, may improvement, lalong-lalo na pag nagawa lahat ng adjustments na ito, yung succeeding po, makikita natin yung marked improvement. Kasi alam naman po natin lahat, matalino talaga ang Pilipino. Talagang kailangan lang natin talaga, parang cut the fat eh. Doon tayo, mag-focus na tayo sa quality lang. Yun naman po talaga ang habol lang natin. Yeah. And yun naman yung gusto ninyo, yun ang sinasabi
rin
ninyo.
Yes, Your Honor, in the matatag agenda of the Vice President, yung letter G talaga is to give opportunity for teachers to teach better, and what better way to improve the quality of teaching than to motivate them and inspire them with a higher salary grade. So that would be most welcome. Yes.
But again po, asking Ringas, that's why kasama na natin dito si Sir Benjo, Vladimir, and any teacher group that is interested. Lahat po ito, hindi naman po natin, hindi po ito para lang, hindi ito politika eh, na gusto lang natin mag-increase. Ha? Lahat po ito nakakabit po sa quality of education. Lahat po ito nakakabit sa teacher assessment, sa promotions. Gusto po natin masigurado. Swerte lang po natin talaga under the matatag agenda that was disclosed during the Sofitel meeting, ay talaga nakita po doon. Talagang nagkaano ng usapin. With us rin po ngayon umaga, of course, is the Honorable Peter Calderon. Sir, welcome po. On Zoom, I think the Honorable Edwin Olivares is also with us on Zoom. With that, meron ba sa Zoom na gusto magsalita?
Yes po, Sir Chair.
Yes, please state your name and identify po. If you're not, pasensya po, no, maraming nasa Zoom ngayon eh. So hindi ko lang makita lahat.
Yes po.
Yes. Please identify your name and sorry po.
Okay po, Mr. Chair, good morning po sa honorable body po. Magandang umaga. I will open my cam po. Yan. So I am Mr. Dino Busilig, the lead convener of the National Head Teachers Association of the Philippines. So unang-una po sa lahat, nagpapasalamat po kami sa honorable body chaired by Congressman Romulo sa pagkakataon pong binigay sa atin na makapagsalita muli po at makibahagi po sa policy making po ng Kongreso. Ganon din po sa mga kasama po natin, sa mga officialis po ng Department of Education, through ASEC Bringas, good morning po. Kay Sir Benjo, good morning po. Now, meron po ako mga tinake note dito regarding po sa concern naming mga head teachers. So, yun nga po, nabanggita po na Sir Benjo na before, nasa framework po tayo ng substitute bill and nawala po tayo, pero meron pong section 6. Ngayon po, Ang question lang po doon ay, Mr. Chair, is with regards to the promotion. Kasi po, sa ngayon po kasi, as you have said, tatanggalin na yung ratio, yung quota, yung proportion ng teachers para ma-promote in a higher position. Pero dito po sa atin sa section 6, for the option for the incumbent head teachers, wala po yung statement na yon na hindi na po magkakaroon ng quota or ratio to be promoted in a higher HT position. So, kasi ngayon po, ang practice po ngayon, lalo na po ang head teacher 4, 5, and 6, nahingi po ng 21 teachers para lang po ma-promote. Nahingi po ng 21 teachers para po ma-promote. At yun po yung pumipigil. Sa mga kasamahan nating head teachers, meron pong head teacher 3 na more than 15 years, more than 20 years ng head teacher 3, pero hindi po sila na-promote-promote dahil po doon sa quota, dahil doon sa ratio ng teachers. And sana po ma-take note po natin doon sa ating ginagawang substitute bill ang bagay pong ito. And then another thing po, Mr. Chair, Kapag po ba nanatili kami na head teacher, can we assure advancement and exercise of our full potential and qualifications? Ano po? Kasi yung iba gusto nang magpa-retitle kasi nga baka buwagin na nga o abolish. Actually, dito po sa atin sa Section 6, i-re-remain lang po o i-re-retain. Pero wala naman pong sinabi na in the natural occurrence of vacancy, wala na pong sinabi na halimbawa mare-retitle yung position. So para pong ang lumalabas po doon, at the end din po pala ay coterminous o ma-abolish din po yung HT position. Ano po? Ang atin po doon ay sana manatili po ang mga head teachers. Bakit po? Bakit po? Sana manatili sa framework po ng Department of Education. I don't know po from the DepEd. Ano po? Gusto ko din pong direkta na rin itanong, ano po ba ang valid reason bakit po kailangang retitled ang mga head teachers? Because as we all know po, ang ating pong mga key result areas, ang position description form po natin ay nagsasabi po na we are giving administrative and ancillary services sa pagbibigay ng basic quality education sa ating mga paaralan. Sabi nyo nga po, Mr. Chair, we are the quality control. Ano po? And actually, nag-research din po ako, nagbasa din po ako, at nakita ko po na yung retitling po, opo, same salary grade, but reduction, significantly reduce our duties and responsibilities. Kasi po, Mr. Chair, kami po may hawak kami ng mga guro. And then kung kami po ay mariretitle at babalik sa classroom teacher, so mawawala po yon, may diminution of duties and responsibilities, which is against to sa declared policy ng state na kailangan po may job fulfillment and satisfaction. Ano po? So ang akin po dito, sana ay hindi po ganon. Kasi yung head teacher, hindi na patatanggal na po yung head, magiging classroom teacher na lang po. And based sa Supreme Court ruling, it is palpable diminution of responsibilities. Ano po? So sana po ay ma-take note po natin iyon. At sana if we will be placed sa ating position, sana po we can advance and exercise our full potential and qualification. At hindi po tayo hindi po kami manatili na head teacher 3 or kasi nga po doon sa mga quota system. So ito po ay both, ang address ko na po both sa substitute bill and sa DepEd po na sa working IRR. Thank you po, Mr. Chair.
Sir Dino, please stay on para maliwanag tayo.
Sige po.
Sulat sa Section 6 ng substitute measure na ito. Options of incumbent head teachers. All incumbent head teachers may nominate to retain their positions and career progression line under the current career progression. So maliwanag po doon, Sir Dino. Pinili po ninyo na manatili as head teacher. Pero again, Sir Dino, kung mali yung pagkasulat namin, kung may kulang dyan, sabihin mo po sa amin ngayon, ano pa yung kulang dyan? Maliwanag po, all incumbent head teachers may nominate to retain their positions and career progression line. Ibig sabihin po tuloy-tuloy, pag pinili po ninyo. Pero ang sinasabi mo po ngayon, ay tinanggal namin yun. Maliwanag po yun. Maliwanag naman sa wording. Pero kung kulang po ito, we po, na makinig po sa inyo kung ano yung kailangan na wording po dito. Pero maliwanag magpapatuloy po yung career progression line nyo under the current career progression. So,
yes.
Head teacher 1, pag pinili nyo, head teacher 2, head teacher 3, head teacher 4, head teacher 5, mananatili po yun. Maliwanag naman sa Section 6. O hindi pa rin po maliwanag yun?
Maliwanag. Maliwanag po. Yes po, Chairman. Maliwanag naman po. Ang hindi lang po nakikita doon ay kapag po kami halimbawa ay head teacher 6 na, kasi doon po sa baseline po ay master teacher 1 na po. So, are we qualified to be promoted as a school principal? Kasi
Again po, dito ko po ah, Sir Dino, nakasulat.
Yes po.
All incumbent head teachers may nominate to retain their positions and career progression line. So ibig sabihin, yes, head teacher 1, head teacher 2, head teacher 3, head teacher 4, head teacher 5 equivalent to an assistant school principal 1, head teacher 6 which is equivalent to assistant school principal 2 or principal 1. And then nasunod po ninyo, assistant school principal 3, school principal 2, school principal 3, and school principal 4. Hindi pa ho ba sapat yun?
Okay. Sapat po, Mr. Chair. Sapat po yan. Malinaw po. Siguro, ayun na nga lang siguro. Siguro dun sa framework na lang po kung may add natin para clear po sa lahat.
Anong framework?
That we are still.
Ano pong framework? Yun, again po, no? Anong framework po? Para maliwanag po tayo kasi parang na lumalabas na impression dito, may kulang pa yung statement na ito. Pero sabi niyo, sapat na. All incumbent head teachers may nominate to retain their positions and career progression line under the current career progression. Ano pa po yung kulang doon? Anong framework po ang kulang doon na na-assure po kayo, natutuloy po yung linya po ninyo kung piliin ninyo maging head teacher one?
Ano po, based po diyan sa atin pong section 6, ano po. So malinaw naman nga po na tuloy po ang career progression line namin bilang sa school administration career line. Ano po? And yes, we do agree. Ano po? We do agree po with this section 6 po. Ano po? Then siguro po ang lilinawin ko na lang, Mr. Chair, sana po yung pong quota.
Yes.
Yun na lang po sana ang mailagay po dito na wala na pong quota kung ma-promote kami in higher HT position. Yun po siguro, yes. Mr. Chair.
Tama. Sir Dino, nung nagsimula po tayo dito committee meeting na ito, introduce ko po yung unnumbered substitute measure na ito at binanggit ko na po doon na may proposal na po na i-amenda ng Section 10, first sentence. Binasa ko po kanina ang ilalagay na po natin. Teacher shall be promoted based on merit, fitness and competence after a comprehensive performance assessment period, natural vacancy, quota, ratio and proportion, and the like shall no longer be considered or be a basis for promoting teachers. Sinabi ko po yun nung umpisa lang na ipapasok po yun. Kulang po ba yun or pwede na po yun?
Pwede na po. Pwede na po, Mr.
So
Chair.
So other than those two po, meron pa ba na issue na mahalaga po sa amin na makuha lahat ng inputs po ninyo? Meron po pa ba?
Siguro po, Mr. Chair, ang gusto ko na lang i-point dito kasi nga po, ongoing po din kasi yung working draft ng IRR ng EO174 and then ito nga pong ating substitute bill na pinag-uusapan ngayon. Ano po? We don't know po ano po kung paanong mangyayari kasi nga po the Congress meron na pong career progression na bill and then ang DepEd po ngayon ang tatlong agencies po ay meron ding ongoing working draft ano po although hinihingi po ang input namin and insights ng DepEd ano po maganda rin po na napakinggan po ninyo kami yun nga lang dun po kasi sa ongoing IRR ay dehado po talaga kami kasi retitling para po sa amin yun ay demotion. Anyway, dito po sa ating substitute bill, malino naman po. Thank you po.
So, supported niyo po ba ito, Sir Dino? Or gusto niyo?
Yes.
Yes,
yes okay. Po. 100% fully support po ang NATA. Thank you po.
Thank you, Sir Dino. Siguro gusto ko lang last. Ano, yes, Asig Bringas.
Thank you, Your Honor. Let me just cite yung sinasabi ni Dino na quota for the classification of the current school head positions. We have DepEd Order Number 97 Series of 2011 on reclassification of school heads. At very specific provision doon, except for HT1 and P1, the reclassification to higher head teacher positions shall no longer be based on the number of teachers. It is there. It is a 2011 DepEd order. So yung quota system for HT2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are no longer applicable but based on merit and performance alone.
Thank you, Asig Bringas. I think maliwan. Yes. Asig Bringas, last na, no? Sinabi mo kanina reclassification. I think yung wording natin dapat dito, may reclassification pero meron pa rin creation of new items. Hindi pa pwede na puro reclassify kasi pag puro reclassify tayo, kawawa naman yung na-reclassify na tight na position. Baka mawala yun. Ang kulang nga tayo ng teachers, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor. We still have reduction of teacher one positions on an annual basis because of the increasing number of enrollment, and we have to balance the teacher pupil ratio to an ideal.
Ideal natin ay mababa natin yung teaching hours ng teachers, di ba? Hindi dapat 5 or 6 hours nagtuturo ang teacher. Naintindihan ko mo ngayon, kulang tayo ng teachers. Pero ang ideal po natin, dapat mababa natin yun para talaga makapag-focus yung teachers sa pagtuturo. Yun naman ang goal nating lahat, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor, in compliance with the Magna Carta for Teachers, 6 hours of actual teaching load is the full load of a teacher. Anything beyond that should
mabigat
be.
Mabigat yun, di ba?
Yeah, it is.
Mabigat yun. Gusto natin mababasa yun. Naintindihan ko, kulang pa tayo ng teachers. I think we are trying to strive for that ideal time na wala na po yung teachers po magtuturo lang ng less than 5 hours sana.
Yes,
para talagang makadevote, matutukan po nila yung kanilang mga student learners, and yung pag-enhance po talaga no pagtuturo nila. Yun naman, I think yun yung aim ninyo eh. Yun yung narinig ko po during the
Yes, Your Honor, that is our primary purpose is to increase the number of teachers and at the same time increase the number of non-teaching positions.
That's
what makes up the time of teachers. Take them out from teaching are the non-teaching jobs.
Yes,
so both creation of teaching and non-teaching positions in the department would help us.
Congress po is, it will really try its best po to help you out kasi talagang ideal po yun eh. But before we proceed, may I also welcome in person from the ako, Ilocano ako, party list, the Honorable Richelle Singson. Welcome po.
Chair, may comment lang ako doon sa 6 hours minimum.
Yes.
Yes, kasi Mr. Chair, talagang medyo mabigat talaga sa teachers yung 6 hours. Na kasi sa Magna Carta, Mr. Chair, yun yung maximum. Ang ginagawa ng DepEd kasi, yun ang ginagawang sineset nila as minimum. So tama kayo, Mr. Chair. Talagang si Mr. Chair talagang naintindihan niya yung cost ng mga teachers. So yun dapat ang aim natin, so that not maximum yung not a minimum yung 6 hours of classroom teaching, so that the teachers could have more time for a one-to-one discussion with the students, especially yung mga elementary, Mr. Chair.
And in fairness po, I think I also heard that not only from the owner, kayo din nagbanggit sa akin yan eh, pero pati DepEd po nagbabanggit sa akin. In fact, ang DepEd is striving towards that. Pero ang problema nga, Congress must help them out eh. Kailangan tulungan din po natin talaga ang DepEd. So makuha nila yon. With that, again, sa online, nako, may mga nakataas po ang kamay. Si Dino nakakit ulit ang kamay? Dino?
Yes po, Mr. Chair. Meron lang po akong comment na konti doon po kay Asik Bringas. With regards po doon sa DO 97-2011, performing as school head lang po siya from the elementary, ang understanding po ng nasa field ngayon. Kaya po, meron pa rin po kaming quota ng teachers. Kasi kami pong nasa secondary academic department head, nihingan po kami ng quota ng teachers. While in the elementary, pwede po yon na HT1 o P1 na kapag nag-hire up na sila, hindi na naka-anchor sa number of teachers. Pero kami po, bilang mga nasa secondary sa junior high school, kami po ay hinihingan sa ngayon po, Mr. Chair, sa ngayon po. Thank you po.
Okay. Pero Dino, maliwanag naman yung provision na i-amend natin, di ba? So ma-address yung concern ninyo?
Yes po, okay. Mr. Chair. Thank you po.
DBM, nakikita ko nakataas rin ang kamay ng DBM. Please state your name and position po sa DBM.
Good morning, Mr. Chair. This is Perpetual Judea Quiason from DBM Budget Information Legislative Service, Chief Budget and Management Specialist po. Sir, we just would like to clarify po dun po sa... Yun po kasing 28.8 billion na funding requirement, that is a computation that we provided the committee in the last meeting for teachers 1, 2, and 3 only from to be reclassified from salary grades 11, 12, 13 into salary grades 12, 13, and 14 respectively. So hindi po siya para sa lahat. So yun po kaninang nabanggit ni Asek Bringas na magbabanggaan na po talaga sa dulo. Yun po yung talagang mangyayari dito. So we suggest po to clarify in the bill hanggang saan po yung ito pong proposal natin, kasi doon po sa section 8 po ng bill on the salary, ang stated lang po dito, in order to attract and retain the top talents, the minimum salary, base salary for teachers under DepEd shall not be lower than salary grade 12. So, ibig sabihin po, parang dire-diretso po siya, pero yun nga po, magbabanggaan po sa dulo. So, sana po, sir, ma-clarify po ito sa bill. Yun lamang po, marami pong salamat.
Well, Ma'am Perpetual, please stay on, Ma'am Perpetual. Yes. Alam po ninyo, nung napag-usapan po ito sa committee, una po, ang intindi namin na pinag-uusapan doon was binangga po ninyo to under EO-174. Kasi last ano pa po yun, administration yung EO-174. Ngayon, nare-reclassify po, ang interpretation po namin, nung sinubmit po sa amin, yung mga numbers po na ito, ay taking to account na po yung career progression under EO-174. So ngayon, ang sinasabi po ninyo, hindi pa pala yun sa EO-174 or yung creation of new items. So again po, no, hindi para sa amin na iklaro dito sa bill. Ang kailangan po, i-run po ninyo ang numbers at i-submit po ninyo sa amin, because sa inyo rin po nang galing yung numbers na yon, yung salary grade 12 at yung salary grade 13. And yung discussion po the time was EO-174, yung career progression doon. Ito po, medyo it mirrors EO-174, except that nag-accommodate po tayo dito yung para sa head teachers natin at nagdagdag tayo ng isa pang item. Pero more or less po, ang in-accommodate natin dito are the head teachers para hindi sila ma-displace. And then now po, you are coming here to this committee at this last hours po to tell us po na iba yung understanding namin sa sinabi po ninyo dati. So ganito po gawin natin, Ma'am Perpetual, para maliwanag. Siguro po, nasasubmit naman po, nandito kayo ng mga hearing na ito, ng mga nakarang hearing. Tingnan po ninyo itong substitute measure po na ito. Ang accommodate lang naman ito ay yung head teachers. May kita niyo rin po dyan yung salary grades, which will mirror yung EO-174 in a way po. At kayo po ang bumalik sa amin dito sa committee at sabihin po ninyo, based on the unnumbered substitute measure, ano po yung numbers na nararan ng DBM? Pwede po ba namin maasahan yon? Bibigyan namin sa inyo yung substitute measure na ito, run the numbers, then go back to this committee with a new and final report po. Will that be possible po?
Yes, sir, we will do that. So ang understanding po kasi namin dun sa last hearing po, ang ni-request po sa DBM is yung para sa teachers 1, 2, and 3. Kaya yun pong pinresent ng DBM in the last hearing para lang po sa teachers 1, 2, and 3. But we will do po yung as requested niyo po ngayon, sir. We will,
para maliwanag po, para walang excuse po, ha. Kasi unang-una, kung teacher 1, 2, 3 lang ang gagalaw, eh magkakaroon po ng problema habang paangat. Kaya parang hindi naman logical. Parang it defies common sense na hindi na consider lahat. Kasi ho, talagang may domino effect eh. Pero again po, para hindi naman tayo, lahat naman po tayo makakampi dito eh. Lahat po tayo, ang gusto lang natin, mapagandang quality ng edukasyon para sa learners natin. So we will give you this substitute measure. Please po, when will you be able to submit the numbers po to this committee? Assuming mamaya po, mabibigay namin sa inyo. When will you be able to submit to the committee the new numbers that or the reviewed numbers po, based on the unnumbered substitute measure? Kailan niyo po masasubmit? Honest to goodness po, ah.
Hindi po ako makapagsabi, sir, na ano, kasi I will refer this to the bureau in charge sa Organization, Position, Classification, and Compensation Bureau. Sila po ang may mandate para po doon sa nire-request. But meron naman pong technical staff na naka online po sa ngayon. So, naririnig din po nila yung nire-request po ng committee.
O sino po yun? Pakibanggit po yung pangalan para ma-recognize namin at makausap namin ng diretso. Sino po?
Sa ngayon po, naka-login din po si Ma'am Precious Anna Marie Lazaro. So
sino Ma'am Lazaro?
Yes, Mr. Chair. So
Ma'am Precious Lazaro po. Ma'am Precious Lazaro.
Good morning po, Mr. Chair.
Yes, Ma'am Precious, nakikinig naman po kayo dun sa exchange po namin ni Ma'am Perpetual.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes. So ang kailan po namin matatanggap from your office, from the DBM, specifically siguro po from your office, yung numbers po na ilalaran ninyo based on the unnumbered substitute measure po na ito, on the increase po of the salary level from salary grade 11 to salary grade 12.
Mr. Chair, we'll try po within the week to submit the requested documents.
Sige, 1 week po. Baka reasonable. Salamat. So we will expect po within 1 week. I think that's reasonable enough. Okay po ba sa lahat yun? Yes. Salamat. Anong name?
Precious.
Ma'am Precious. Salamat, Ma'am Precious. Salamat, Ma'am Perpetual. So we will wait po 1 week so that we can see the numbers that you will give us naman po.
Mr. Chair, thank you.
Thank you. Yes, ma'am. One minute.
Yes.
With the permission of the members and of invited guests, I think talagang sa totoo we wanted to approve this committee, this report, bill this morning. Pero now that DBM gives us this number, I think it is reasonable for everyone to wait for 1 week. Or do you want to approve the same first? What is the pleasure of the members? 1 minute suspension. This committee meeting is now resumed. Honorable Magsino is recognized.
Mr. Chair, I move that the we have to wait for the 1 week deadline that DBM has given us to be able to move forward, and then let's take it one by one, and we have to make the final decision after 1 week, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion by the Honorable Marisa, signed by the Honorable Marisa Magsino, signed by the Honorable June Gato, that we suspend consideration for purposes of waiting for the updated information to come from the DBM. Is there any objection? The chair hearing none, the same is approved. A 1 minute suspension para maka-bathroom break lahat. Okay. This committee meeting is... This committee meeting is now resumed. We proceed now with the next matter in the agenda. Deliberation resolutions, House Resolution Number 711, resolution congratulating Cebu City National Science High School for winning most outstanding secondary school in the 2022 DepEd Region 7 Pasidungong by Representative Eduardo R. Rama. The author was with us earlier. Is the Honorable Rama still with us?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. I'm moving for its approval. So move.
Yes, with that, first, we could we, with the permission of the Honorable Rama, you have one to also the next House Resolution Number 725, resolution congratulating Andrew Lorenz Kawanan Kabigon and Matthew Andre Go for winning gold medals International Junior Math Olympiad held last December 4, 2022 in Singapore. Honorable Rama, with your permission, may we just ask those invited guests for initial comments before we move to approve? Will that be okay, Honorable Rama?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes. First, from the Department of Education, who from the Department of Education will represent the DepEd for purposes of House Resolution 711?
Mr. Chairman, via Zoom is Ms. Lyra Eliaga of DepEd Cebu City Schools Division and Dr. Charlie Salve, the principal of Cebu City Science High School.
Yes. Sino po sa mga nabanggit ang unang magsasalita? Sir Charlie, will you be the first one? Or sino po yung maunang magsalita? Okay, from the Schools Division, Ma'am Lyra, are you still with us?
Yes, good morning po, Mr. Chairman.
Good morning, Ma'am Lyra. Ma'am Lyra, any comments on House Resolution 711?
I move that resolution will be approved, Mr. Chairman. Cebu City National Science High School is one of the secondary schools of DepEd Cebu City Division who won for the Pasidungog Most Outstanding Secondary School. And with me here in the Zoom is the school principal of Cebu City National Science High School in the person of Dr. Charlie Salve. He's also here with us, Mr. Chair.
So we understand po, Ma'am Lyra, that you fully support House Resolution Number 711.
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Ma'am Lyra. Sir Charlie, could we also get comments from you?
Yes, good morning, Mr. Chair. Good morning, everyone. I would just like to thank Honorable Rama and of course our SGOD Chief Dr. Eliaga. This is Charlie Salve from Cebu City National Science High School, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Charlie. And of course, we understand that you are fully supportive of House Resolution 711.
Thank you.
From
thank
the City you. Government of Cebu, meron po, meron bang dumating, meron ba tayong, wala? From the Department of Education, Samin, is there anyone authorized to represent DepEd for purpose of House Resolution 711?
We fully support the measure to congratulate the city the city school in Cebu City, Your Honor.
Yes. From the members, any comments or any motion from the members?
I move to approve the House Resolution Number 711, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion by the Honorable Magsino, signed by the Honorable Gato, that we approve House Resolution Number 711. Is there any objection? Chair, hearing none, same is approved. Congratulations to the Honorable Rama. The next one is House Resolution Number 725, also from the Honorable Eduardo R. Rama. From the Department of Education, is there any comment? Asik Bringas. Resolution congratulating Mr. Kabigon and Mr. Go for winning gold medals in the International Junior Math Olympiad held last December 4, 2022 in Singapore.
We offer our congratulations as well, and we have no objection, Your Honor.
Hiro Asik Blingas from the DOST. Is there anyone from the Department of Science and Technology, COMSEC? They were sent invitations, but they are not with us. The city government of Cebu was also sent invitations. Yes, from the schools division of Cebu City, Ma'am Lyra, kayo po yun. Do you have any comments? Yes.
Yes, Mr. Chair, I fully support that resolution congratulating our student.
Thank you, Ma'am Lyra. What about Sir Charlie?
Yes, Mr. Chair, I fully support for the approval of that resolution.
Yes. COMSEC, kasama rin ba natin yung school principal from the Sacred Heart School or Ateneo de Cebu?
We have invited the principals of Ateneo de Cebu, Your Honor, but we received no reply.
Okay. What is the pleasure of Honorable Gato?
Mr. Chair, I move for the approval of House Resolution Number 725. I so move, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion by the Honorable Gato, duly signed by the Honorable Calderon and Honorable Castro that we adopt and approve House Resolution Number 725. Is there any objection? Chair, hearing none, same is approved. Congressman Rama, congratulations on your two House resolutions.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Honorable Rama.
I second the motion, Mr. Chair.
Yes, duly noted, Honorable Magsino. The next is House Resolution Number 770, Resolution congratulating and commending the members and coaches of the Philippine Robotics National Team from Narvacan National Central High School in Narvacan, Ilocos Sur, for bagging 8 gold and silver medals in the 2022 World Robot Games held in Thailand last December 11, 2022 by Deputy Speaker Christine Singson Meehan and the Honorable Richelle Singson. The Honorable Singson is with us this morning. If she wishes to sponsor her House resolution.
Mr. Chair, may I read my short sponsorship remarks?
Yes, please proceed, Honorable Singh.
Yung screen ko wala. Ayan, walang screen.
Thank you for the early consideration of House Resolution 770, congratulating and commending the members and coaches of the Philippine Robotics National Team from Narvacan National Central High School in Narvacan for bagging 8 gold and silver medals in the 2022 World Robot Games held in Thailand on December 11, 2022. We are indeed very proud of our young students for their incredible achievement and for bringing honor not only to Ilocanos, but to all Filipinos as well. Their amazing accomplishment should serve as an inspiration to our youth. Robotics is an interactive approach to science, technology, engineering, and math, or STEM for short. Hence, it's also called, STEM for short. It involves engineering and computer science incorporated with design, construction, operation, application, and computer systems to produce something called robots. It teaches children more than science, robotics, and mathematic concepts. The focus on hands-on learning with real
world systems. Ba't ako wala?
Yes, Honorable, please proceed. Please continue.
The focus on hands-on learning with real-world applications help develop a variety of skill sets, including creativity, problem-solving, critical thinking, decision-making, and leadership. The importance of robots and artificial intelligence, or AI, in the modern world cannot be overemphasized. Robots in the healthcare industry, manufacturing industry, military service, logistics, and other fields have proven very important because robots are cost-effective, increase productivity, and have better quality work output. We should therefore encourage our young learners to become creative problem solvers, critical thinkers, decision makers, and future leaders through robotics. In view of these considerations, I request the expeditious approval of HR 770 by this committee. Thank you.
Thank you, Honorable Singson. With that, any member who wants to...
Mr. Chair?
Yes?
Mr. Chair, I move to adopt House Resolution Number 770. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion by the Honorable Magsino, duly signed by the Honorable Calderon, Honorable Castro, Honorable Gato, that we approve adopt and approve House Resolution Number 770. Is there any objection? Chair, hearing none. Same is approved and adopted. Congratulations, Honorable Singson, and thank you.
Mr.
Yes, Honorable Magsino.
I
that all the legislators present and in the Zoom VPO authors of the House Resolution 770. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Yung iba ayaw mo.
With the permission of the author of
the omnibus mo na.
I move that all House Resolution number 711, House Resolution 725, and House Resolution 770, that all legislators present today and in the Zoom be co-authors of the said House Resolution. So move, Mr. Chair.
It's a motion by the Honorable Magsino, duly signed by the Honorable Gato and Castro, that all member, with the permission of the authors for House Bills House Resolution number 711, 725, and 770, all members present who wish to become co-authors be made co-authors. Is there any objection? Hearing none, same is approved. Thank you. And again, congratulations to the Honorable Rama and the Honorable Singson. Congratulations, po.
Congrats.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Next is deliberation on local school bills. House Bill number 5590, an act establishing a senior high school in Progressive Village 3, Bayanan City of Bacoor, Province of Cavite, to be known as Progressive Senior High School and appropriating funds therefore, by the Honorable Lani Mercado Revilla. The Honorable Revilla is recognized.
Yes, Honorable Chairman Roman Romulo, distinguished members of the Committee on Basic Education, fellow authors, guests, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant noon to all of us. First and foremost, I thank the committee through Chairman Romulo for its swift approval of another bill which I have earlier filed, House Bill 3133, which seeks the establishment of Mariano Gomez National High School. The bill was recently heard in the Senate and I am hopeful that it will be passed into law soon. This humble representation is once again seeking the indulgence of this committee as I sponsor House Bill 5590, which seeks to establish the Progressive Senior High School in Progressive Village 3, Bayanan, City of Bacoor, and House Bill 5591, which seeks to establish the Progressive Elementary School in Progressive 15, Barangay Molino 2, City of Bacoor. The senior high school in Progressive is already in operation, having been established in 2016 through the joint efforts of the DepEd and the city government of Bacoor during this representation's term as mayor of Bacoor City. Currently, it is composed of 22 teaching personnel, 7 non-teaching personnel, and has an enrollment size of 725. The Progressive Elementary School, on the other hand, has also been operating for several years now and has been instrumental in educating children in 7 barangays in Bacoor City, namely Molino 1, Molino 2, Molino 3, Molino 4, Molino 5, Molino 6, and Molino 7, as well as the nearby barangays of Queens Row East, West, Central, and Bayanan. In spite of their very significant roles as education institutions, however, both schools still do not have their own identification and mandate to institutionalize the operation of both schools with full budgetary support from the national government and ensure the delivery and access to quality basic education, I hope that the Committee on Basic Education, through its honorable chairman and members, will approve the said measures. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Honorable Lani Mercado Revilla. House Bill number 5590, an act establishing a senior high school in Progressive Village 3, and also House Bill number 5591, an act establishing an elementary school in Progressive 15, Barangay Molino 2, City of Bacoor, Province of Cavite. Both House Bills authored by the Honorable Lani Mercado Revilla have been sponsored by the author for both bills. That is my understanding. Is that correct, Honorable Lani? Pareho na, no? Na-sponsor mo na pareho?
Parehas na po. Parehas na po, Mr. Thank you.
With that, may we ask first the DepEd Central Office or main office if they have any comments on any of the House Bills, House Bill number 5590 and House Bill 5591. Asik Bringas, will you be the responsible officer?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chair. The Department of Education interposes no objection to the establishment of Progressive Elementary and Progressive High School, as it was already certified by the Schools Division of Office that they have complied with all the requirements of DepEd Order 40 Series of 2014, Your Honor.
Thank you, Asik Bringas. So for both House Bills, ano, yung senior high school and the elementary.
Yes, Your Honor.
May we ask confirmation or comments from the Regional Director of DepEd Region 4A? Dr. Danilo Ilagan? Supervisor, di ba? Regional Yes. There are two representatives present here from Region 4A. One is the Chief of Quality Assurance, Dr. Luz Osmeña, and the other one is Supervisor of 4A Regional Office, Dr. Danilo Ilagan. Who will speak first, Dr. Ilagan or Dr. Osmeña?
Yes, Honorable Chair, may I speak on behalf of our Regional Director?
Yes, please, your name.
Yes, I'm Luz Osmeña, the Quality Assurance Division Chief of the Regional Office, Region 4, Calabarzon. Now, the Regional Office concurs and is in full support with the Legislative Proposal House Bill 5590, an act establishing a senior high school in Progressive Village 3, Bayanan City of Bacoor, Province of Cavite, introduced by the Representative Lani Mercado Revilla, and furthermore certifies that it complies with the documentary requirements stated in DepEd Order Number 51 Series 2015, the establishment of a standalone senior high school. And likewise, the Regional Office also concurs and is in full support with the Legislative Proposal House Bill 5591, an act establishing an elementary school in Barangay Molino 2, City of Bacoor, Province of Cavite, introduced by Representative Lani Mercado Revilla, and furthermore certifies that it complies with the documentary requirements stated in DepEd Order Number 40, Series of 2014. Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you. Dr. Osmeña, you also speak already on behalf of Dr. Ilagan? Or is
yes, he, sir.
Yes, you've been offered to speak in behalf of the region. Thank you. So, Dr. Osmeña, the region 4A fully supports House Bills number 5590 and House Bill number 5591.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. From the Schools Division's office, Dr. Cesar Mojica, are you with us?
Yes, Honorable Chair.
Yes, Dr. Mojica, do you have any comments on House Bills 5590-5591?
Yes, I would like to speak on behalf of our Schools Division Superintendent, Dr. Edita M. Atendido, who's not able to attend this hearing due to her prior commitment to equally important engagement. The City Schools Division of Bacoor therefore fully support and concurs that there are merits for the approval of House Bill number 5590 entitled Establishing Senior High School in Progressive Village 3, Bayanan City of Bacoor, Province of Cavite, to be known as Progressive Senior High School and appropriating funds therefore, to ensure that the quality, effective, and efficient delivery of basic education is accessible to all young Bacooreño. Likewise, the SDO Bacoor City fully supports and concurs the urgency and relevance of the approval of the House Bill 5591 entitled Establishing an Elementary School in Progressive 15 Barangay Molino 2, City of Bacoor, Province of Cavite, to be known as Progressive Elementary School and appropriating funds therefore. For the purpose of decentralization of school administration towards quality, effective, and efficient delivery of basic education for the benefit of young Bacooreño learners. Thank you very much.
And Dr. Mojica, in support, we also understand that all requirements have been submitted and have been reviewed and submitted and acceptable to the Schools Division's office.
Yes, Honorable Chair. This is also in compliance with the documentary requirements that have been complied with the House Bill 5991 and the other one, which is
I-590.
All the documentary requirements have been complied with the DepEd Division Office as regards to DepEd Order Number 40, Series of 2014, and DepEd Order Number 51, Series of 2015, respectively.
Thank you, Dr. Mojica.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Yes, Honorable Marisa Magsino from the Party List OFW.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I move that omnibus motion to approve House Bills 5590 and House Bill 5591, Mr. Chair. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion by the Honorable Marisa Magsino that we approve House Bills number 5590 and 5591. Duly sent by the Honorable Gato and Honorable Calderon. Is there any objection? Chairing none, same is approved. Congratulations to the Honorable Lani Mercado Revilla.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Right. Salamat po sa lahat ng members. Salamat.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Honorable Castro, while the Honorable Revilla is still with us, Honorable Castro.
So, Mr. Chair, with the permission of the author, Representative Revilla, may I move that the all members present in our meeting will be made co-author.
I second.
No.
There's a motion by the Honorable Castro, duly sent by the Honorable Magsino Ingato, with the permission of the author of House Bill number 5590 and 5591, that all members present who wish to become co-authors be made co-authors. Is there any objection? I think Honorable Mercado Revilla is still with us.
Yes, no problem, Mr. Chair. Thank you very much for the support. Thank you.
There being no objection, the same is approved. We now proceed to deliberation of classroom management support and protection for teacher bills. This is the last matter in our agenda. First, House Bill is House Bill number 364, an act institutionalizing support mechanisms for public school teachers and school personnel in matters of student discipline and mechanisms for classroom management and providing for their protection in cases related thereto by the Honorable Marisa Magsino. Honorable Magsino is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. To our colleagues, good afternoon po to our resource people. Mr. Chair, House Bill number 364. In law, our family code and the civil code recognize our teachers and school administrators as having special or substitute parental authority and responsibility over minors under their supervision in all authorized activities, whether inside or outside the school premises. This is the concept of loco parentis. These provisions underline the duty of our teachers and school personnel within the scope of their authority to discipline our students and ensure their good behavior in school. After all, when our children misbehave in school and cause trouble while under their custody, it would be them who would be liable by law. The prevalence of problematic and disruptive student behavior in schools has called attention to the need to train our educators to effectively manage their classes through appropriate discipline strategies to promote the student's sense of responsibility in the classroom and to produce more responsible citizens. But it should also be in the context of a non-threatening learning environment which develops a sense of belonging among students, makes them self-initiated and self-confident, and thus increases their desire for learning. Unfortunately, when our teachers and school personnel exercise their duty to discipline our students within their scope of authority, they are subjected to complaints by the parents and ridicule by the public. These attacks effectively hamper them from fully discharging their duties, afraid of losing their jobs or having their reputation smeared. Mr. Chair, House Bill number 364 seeks to implement classroom management guidelines to be formulated by the Department of Education and applicable to all teaching personnel and non-teaching personnel who come in direct contact with students in the performance of their duties in all public schools. These guidelines will define permissible, appropriate, and effective responses to address violations of school regulations, describe clear disciplinary procedures, and identify authorities competent to apply responses and interventions. Most importantly, the guidelines will lay down the rules and regulations to be observed and the rights and responsibilities of teaching and non-teaching personnel with respect to student discipline and classroom management to the end of fostering a positive and safe school environment conducive to learning. In particular, Mr. Chair, this bill protects teachers and school personnel from the burden of legal suits by providing that their actions will not be deemed child abuse when done within the bounds of law and in the exercise of their functions. But it also ensures that no abuse would take place. Striking a balance is always necessary. In view of the foregoing, Mr. Chair, this humble representation request that the committee approves House Bill number 364. Thank you so much, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Honorable Marisa. There are two other measures which deal with the same subject matter. May we recognize the author of the House Bill number 549, which also deals with the same subject matter. This House Bill number 549 is authored by the Honorable Franz Castro, Arlene Rosas, and Raul Daniel Manuel. The Honorable Franz Castro is present with us this morning. If she so wishes to sponsor said measure, please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. So in behalf of my colleagues in the Makabayan Block, Representative Arlene Rosas and Representative Raul Daniel Manuel, I am sponsoring our House Bill number 549. This is entitled An Act Institutionalizing Support Mechanism and Protection for Public School Teachers and Personnel in Matters of Student Discipline for Classroom Management, or in short, Teacher Protection Bill. So this was submitted, Mr. Chair, as a bill in the 16th Congress, and in the 17th Congress, it was approved on the third reading. However, due to lack of material time in the Senate, it was not tackled. Again, we are filing this Teacher Protection Act, which aims to, number one, our principle is that the child protection is indispensable, but teacher protection is also a must. So the bill seeks to lay down institutionalized support mechanisms for teachers and school personnel in matters of classroom management and discipline. So for us to do that, there should be a guidelines, okay, on implementation of the teacher protection. And also provide pre-service and in-service training for DepEd personnel, child behavior and psychology, for positive discipline and other related fields. And also, these measures propose to protect teachers and school personnel in cases related to school discipline, classroom management, including legal assistance and representation by council or union or association representatives. So this representation, Mr. Chair, sought the approval of this bill. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Honorable Castro. The third measure on the same subject matter is House Bill number 6940, authored by the Honorable Edwin Olivares. Honorable Magsino.
Our colleague, Congressman Edwin Olivares, is not present today. So I would like to sponsor House Bill 6940 and the explanatory note be made as the sponsorship speech of Congressman Olivares. I move, Mr. Chair.
I second the motion, Mr. Chair.
There is a motion by the Honorable Magsino, joined by the Honorable Castro, that the explanatory note of House Bill number 6940 be made its sponsorship remarks for purposes of this committee meeting. Is there any objection? The chair hearing none, the same is approved. Can we have a 1-minute suspension?
Okay.
para may move na natin. Alika. Sa harmonize na lang natin. Para tapos na.
Same lang.
May isang PWG tayo.
Same lang yata.
It's just the same.
Para lang, let's just make sure.
Okay.
This committee meeting is resumed. Before I recognize the Honorable Magsino, may I request our guests this here this morning to provide us with a written position paper on this matter. Of course, we have here with us Sir Vladimir, you will provide us, Sir Benjo. And of course, with the Department of Education, could we get a written position paper? Honorable Magsino?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. May I move that we have to consolidate House Bill number 364, House Bill 549 and House Bill 6940 and create at least a one-time TWG to further enhance and improve the House Bills for the ACT institutionalizing support mechanisms on matters of student discipline and classroom management. So move, Mr. Chair.
The motion.
There is a motion by the Honorable Magsino, Julie, seconded by the Honorable Castro, both authors of the measure, that we form a technical working group to consolidate the three measures and to finalize the provisions for purposes of creating a substitute measure for consideration of the members of this committee. Is there any objection? The chair hearing none, the same is approved.
Ano pa? Finish na.
The TWG, I understand, will be headed by the Honorable Castro, since I think you have been filing this measure, you are very familiar with.
Yeah.
With the permission of the Honorable Magsino.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. With that, unless there is any other matter that any member wishes to bring up for purposes of committee meeting? Kung wala?
May I move to adjourn the committee, Mr. Chair?
There's a motion by the Honorable Marisa Magsino and Julie Sambit, Honorable Paz Castro, that we adjourn this committee meeting. Is there any objection? Chair hearing none, same is approved. Thank you to all persons who participated and all the members. Maraming salamat.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Thank you very much.